everybody. Welcome to Sunday Streaming. It's 2017. It's the first Sunday Streaming of 2017. It's Rage Select. It's here. I'm Jeff.
I'm John.
Amanda.
Okay. And it's Ultimate Marvel versus Capcom 3.
It's the Ultimatists.
It's the what?
Ultimatists.
Ultimatists?
It's the most ultimate.
It's the most ultimate of all time.
The only thing it would not be is infinite.
Oh, okay. All right.
Because, you know, that comes out later this year.
Oh, right. Wait, what's going on here? We got a comic book about...
There came a day like no other.
Okay.
That's all it said in that one page?
When the very fabric of two universes began to unravel and collide.
Is the Hulk beating up one of those... Was that Wesker versus Hulk?
And yet, the cause of this disastrous occurrence was not a natural one. Rather, it was unnatural.
Okay.
As villains from the two very different worlds united with an eye on conquering both.
Goodness gracious, John is into it.
Their vile scheme would throw their respective realities into chaos!
Oh, no!
This is why I can't watch movies with subtitles with him.
By meddling with forces they could not even possibly comprehend, and by angering a god... I am that god! I, Galactus!
Is that what Galactus sounds like?
Sure, why not?
Oh, silly Galactus. So, yep. All right. So, let's see. Should we do a little bit of skirmishing between the three of us before we start this
Yeah,
this out?
Sure. That's fine.
Because I got to say right now...
Vices!
Hey, if you guys out there that are watching are new, it doesn't sound like anybody in the chat is new, but... what?
Same old people.
Press the options button on Player 2's DualShock 4 controller. There you go. I don't know how to play this game worth a shit.
I don't remember how to play this game.
Just not even a little bit. So, yeah. I can't guarantee that this is going to be anything other than a complete and total crap fest. And then anybody who actually knows how to play this game, I am 100% asking you to tell me tips and tricks in the chat because... I don't know how to play this game. All I know is that
extra points if you tell them the wrong thing.
I want to play Phoenix Wright. I want to be Phoenix Wright real bad. Ooh, and Frank West. There we go. These are some ridiculous Capcom characters. Who else is ridiculous? Amanda, who's a ridiculous Capcom character? Tronbon?
Looks like it.
It's pretty ridiculous.
Maybe.
Oh, wait, Mike Hagar. Oh, wait, you're already Mike Hagar.
Are you going to be pure Capcom people?
Yes.
No, then let me back out of this and I'll be pure Marvel.
That's fine.
People.
You can do whatever you want to.
He's made the decision.
Boom, look at that. That's a ridiculous lineup.
All right.
Well. Makes sense. I can see it. Nova.
Alex, Galactus is not a big fart cloud. You know better than that. It's just one bad movie. Nova, Iron Fist. I feel like this is like the Jason Murphy team that you're putting together right here.
Darkman says, just punch and kick Jeff. Okay. I don't know if he's telling you that's what you should do or recommending that we do that to you.
Just take Jeff outside and hit him with a tire iron.
Punch and kick him. He's fine.
It'll be fine. It'll be fine.
Show me your moves.
All right. So, yeah, it's been...
Battle?
I played this a little bit earlier before we
Oh, good, because I haven't played it at all.
Well, I just wanted to make sure that it wasn't the worst of all time. Wait, what is he doing? Is he he's looking for clues? Well, that's not a good fighting move.
That was not what I wanted to do.
You hit me.
That
so.
Was a button.
Oh, okay, apparently I'm like... What am I doing? This isn't fighting Phoenix Wright. What are you doing, Phoenix Wright?
Why would you pick a lawyer?
I thought he had moves. I thought he had...
Show me your moves.
Oh, wait. So his move is put up the...
Did a girl just fucking faceplant into Hawkeye?
I think so. Oh, that's my assistant. Yeah. Oh, he just tripped. Okay. I'm going to see if I can bring in somebody else who's not Phoenix Wright. Because I apparently, as much as I would like to play Phoenix Wright, I don't understand how to play Phoenix Wright. Uh-oh. Oh. Okay, now I'm back to Phoenix Wright. Allow me to hit you with my legal briefs, John.
Don't pull your underwear out at me.
No. Okay. How about Frank West?
There's nothing legal about those briefs.
Frank West has. Whoop.
Oh!
Yeah! Bam! Bam! Oh! Have a cart full of zombies, John.
Is this old voice Frank West?
Yes.
Or
new
probably.
Voice Frank West?
This is definitely old voice.
Tronbon. I don't know what any of Tronbon's moves are, but that's all right because Marvel's Capcom. You don't need to know shit.
Fucking. You made the little Lego man cry.
Ah! Damn it.
He's so cute.
Right.
Oh!
Okay. I need to get... Where's Frank? Frank, come in here and stay. Get fucking Hawkeye out of here, man.
Oh, wow. Straight up batted him out of the screen. I'm just looking at the weird police activity in the background of these cops watching people literally vandalize shit and not doing anything.
Get out of here,
yeah,
Nova.
That's...
There's a guy standing on top of a cop car, and then the cops are like, "Sir, please get down from there."
Okay. All right. Okay, that's baseball bat. Maybe something. Wait, was that a zombie? Was that just yanking, throwing zombies at you?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Whipping a zombie around? Whip Nova in the face of the zombie? Wah, fucking get out of here. Let's try Chonbon again. Ooh. Uh-oh. Maybe bring somebody else in. Maybe bring old Phoenix back in. See if I can make him do anything.
Yeah, it might be nice if I could actually, like, at least eliminate one of your guys.
Right.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
What's happening? Why is everyone glowing red?
Because we got the glow!
Because John used and I both used our X. Time's up.
Oh.
Do I win?
Yes.
Yay! That's a really weird windscreen.
And he just walks off. It's funny.
See, I miss the dopey Frank West.
He looks a little Mel Gibson-y.
Alright, let's pick some new characters. Let's see what we got going on here. I kind of want to see what Deadpool is like. And I'm going to pick some Marvel people. So I'll go with the Hulk. And actually, no, go back. I want to go with the She-Hulk.
Who the shit is Spencer?
That's the guy from the new Bionic Commando game that flopped and nobody liked.
Oh, so and nobody. He's nobody.
How about Doctor Doom?
Doctor Doom, Deadpool, and She-Hulk.
Yep. There we go.
Okay.
Oh, did you get, like, the alternate costume for him?
Yeah, I picked the alternate. So, let's see.
Beautiful Joe. Alt. Oh, jeez.
What the hell is that?
Hey, kids.
That's him out of costume.
Do you want a Capri Sun?
I never actually played Beautiful Joe. I always wanted to, but I think when it came out, it was, what, on the
and
Wii?
And then, is this Virgil? Oh, okay.
Chris Redfield? That just looks like regular Chris Redfield. How's that all?
That's his older costume. That's his, like, first game costume.
Oh, okay. Is the other one, like, his big, he's got the guns out, Resident Evil 5 costume?
Yeah, something like that, probably.
Is this funny She-Hulk, or is this I'm a lawyer and should be taken seriously now, She-Hulk?
I have no idea. We'll see if she pulls out a bunch of legal briefs like fucking Phoenix Wright.
Stop picking lawyers!
I must have a lawyer in every team! A little just like Cheese Dick John. Just do the same thing over and over again.
Who's cheese dicking who?
Who made you? No, I am. I was just using... Oh. Apparently Deadpool has like a gun thing that was just kind of like, just do that. Did he just short you, Ken?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he's aware he's in a video game.
Uh-oh. There we go. Okay. Dr. Doom! Oh, God, this is not... He's so small. How am I supposed to fight somebody this small?
He's got such a weird shaped head.
Beautiful Joe?
Yeah.
Shit.
It's beautiful.
Oh, man. Look at John pulling out combos and stuff like he knows how to play this game.
Ha-ha! Fooled you.
Yep.
I can't believe you fell for it.
Okay.
You actually thought I knew how to play.
Oldest trick in the book.
You know who needs to be in Marvel's Capcom Infinite?
What's that?
Squirrel Girl. But then again, she'd be overpowered, so.
Yeah.
Because she's unbeatable.
Exactly.
Is that like a thing in the comics?
That's her comic, Unbeatable Squirrel Girl. Uh-oh. She's defeated Dr. Doom like 3 times.
Yeah. Did I use my X? That was wrong. Or She-Hulk! Uh-oh. Ouch.
just ask if that works?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Damn it, again? No, didn't work the first time. Chris! Mr. Redfield! Deadpool! Oh no! Did you just break Deadpool's neck?
I might have, but he's okay.
He's Deadpool, so it's fine.
What? Alright. Yeah! Amanda, do you want to play?
I don't have to, but I can. Dr. Von Boogie asks, are any of you guys looking forward to Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite? Do you think that the possible lack of X-Men characters and Dr. Doom might hurt the game?
I don't know. I don't really know anything about the technical details of how you actually play this game. So the different characters, I mean, I can kind of see, like, I watched a bunch of this at Evo a few years ago, and I felt like that was where I finally started to kind of understand that, and I actually read some articles about, like, how to play the game a little bit, but I've never gone back to it, so this is kind of interesting. Getting a chance to go back and look at it now that I have a slightly better idea of what it actually takes to play this game.
Did I just double pick Ghost Rider?
Did you even pick Ghost Rider? I don't think you picked Ghost Rider. You still got the two cards.
Okay. I guess John's picking Ghost Rider now.
Yup. Unless you want me not to.
No, it's too late.
Okay.
I don't care anymore.
Yeah, you guys could just pick the same character.
No, that's dumb. That's dumb, Jeff.
That's dumb?
Yeah.
You could always pick a character that we've already played before.
Oh, my God. He's perfect.
That is
MODOK.
That's a crazy MODOK right there. I didn't know there was any version of MODOK where MODOK had hair.
Yeah, that's Elvis MODOK.
Okay.
Clearly.
What's Elvis MODOK? What does that mean?
It's
MODOK with Elvis hair?
Yeah, he's dressed like Elvis.
Okay, thank you, but no, I'm going to require a little bit more than that. Why is he dressed like Elvis?
Because why not?
No. Yeah. That's not the question. The question is why, not why not. I've never seen MODOK dressed as Elvis. Is MODOK an Elvis fan?
Who isn't? Who doesn't like Elvis?
Of course MODOK's an Elvis fan.
You guys are.
You've obviously never read Next Wave.
That's true. Yes, that is 100% true. Is that what it is? Somebody hit the X button for random.
Sorry.
Next Wave, Agents of Hate.
Storm is so sexy.
Yeah?
She's such a babe. You don't think so?
No.
I can't see her because of MODOK's giant fucking dome piece, but...
Because of his hair?
Yeah.
His inexplicable hairdo?
Wait, you gotta give me a minute.
Sorry.
Jesus, I've never played this fucking game.
So it's light, medium, heavy, like square, triangle, circle, or light, medium, heavy, and then X is special. R2 will dash back and forth.
Okay.
L1 and R1 are how you call in your assists. If you hold down L1, they'll come in for good. And if you just tap it, they'll come in and do an attack and then go away. And then by hitting light, medium, heavy, and then special is like a universal combo that everybody has. And then just like fireballs with the various attack buttons are how you do your special attacks and stuff. So.
Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready. You ready?
Let's do this. I'm just going to lose.
Dylan, I think that Hydra Cap came after this game.
Yeah, it did.
I don't think they... I mean, and I don't think that Capcom has really added anything in this game for, what, a couple of years now?
No, yeah, nothing new.
Oh, also, Amanda, the little red part of your bar will regenerate if you take Storm out and bring somebody else in for a little while. I said Amanda, not John. God.
Ah, the ultimate test. Mega Man versus Ghost Rider.
Yeah! Oh, and also, quarter circle forward and R2 does a special attack that will take one of your meters down there. Does Ghost Rider breathe fire much?
Sometimes.
Yeah! Get him, Amanda!
He's so slow! Wait!
MODOK the
shit!
Wait. He's got a microphone!
Don't attack him! I'm sorry, go ahead.
I want you to beat him with MODOK, Amanda! You
bye! Peace out! I'm leaving this bitch!
Out.
Oh,
wait, what is he even doing? Oh, shit.
I don't know. I didn't mean to
do
that.
He's a hunk of burning.
Jesus, his jump is just a gradual incline. It's driving me crazy. I can't even. Literally, you could beat me by just standing on the other edge of the map. It takes so long to get to you.
So you can hit R1 or L1, and the people will, there you go, will come in to just do like a brief attack and then jump back out again.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Give you a little triangle shield or something.
Oh, no.
Why is Phoenix Wright's assistant doing all the attacking? Phoenix Wright is a silly character.
Well, he's not a fighter.
Well, then why is he in a fighting game?
That's a good question.
He should be here to litigate some stuff. I mean, that girl with the whip from the Phoenix Wright series would be better off here. I'd even trust Miles Edgeworth more in a fighting game. That's saying something.
You can't get
MODOK just came in and went, nyah! Oh, shit. What the fuck? You got two of you, Amanda.
Oh, I did
oh, we
not.
Need to put it to, like, infinite time.
Did I
you
win?
Still won, yeah.
Damn.
So I just suck, apparently.
Apparently. You just pick some of the characters that you know how to play.
Dude, I haven't played this game in like since it first came out, and I'm okay. Not even talking about the ultimate version. I'm talking about the original.
Pick Iron Man, Wolverine, and Spider-Man. They're all super easy to play.
You're super easy.
To answer Dr. Von Boogie's question earlier, we are going to play this online, but I thought we'd have a little bit of fun first where everybody's just not dying the
I
entire time.
I just thought we would enjoy playing the game before.
Yes. Just briefly, you know. Not ridiculous or anything. What? Oh my god, is that Frank wearing the costume? The like Mega Man costume or whatever it is?
Yeah.
Oh, and realize
yeah, that was the one I did.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and
oh man.
Next.
Is he supposed to have a TV on his head?
No. Does he have a TV on his head? No, that's what he has on his okay.
Yeah.
It's the prototype of the VR.
Yeah, it's the...
All right.
I'm a raccoon! He's so little! Oh, it's adorable.
It's like pre-Guardians of the Galaxy Rocket Raccoon. Was he in Marvel vs. Capcom 2?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I think it's the first time he was ever in one of these games.
Why did I pick all the short characters?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Why did
you? Why are you fucking flying in the air Wait. When there's no one up there?
Did you pick Thor as well?
Thor
doesn't. He's not a short character. Dr. Rumbuggy says, you guys dropped some Marvel vs. Capcom trivia on us. John, do you know any Marvel vs. Capcom trivia? You're kind of the closest thing we have to an aficionado here.
Oh, God.
Wow, that's the saddest thing.
Are you reading all new Wolverine, John?
I haven't read it in a while, but like it was really good. Like when they started doing the all new, all different Marvel
okay.
stuff, I really like it. A good book.
Yeah.
But I haven't been reading comics in a while, so I am severely out of date when it comes to current Marvel.
That's my fault.
No, it's not your fault.
Did they ever relaunch DC back to the previous continuity or whatever?
It's kinda, no. Yeah, yeah. Sort of.
It's run away from the
Why
action.
Are you running away?
Because she's Arthur.
I don't want to fight Wolverine. I hate him.
Oh, no.
No shit. Yeah, get him. Aw.
Oh. I don't even what?
Boo Thor. Or yay Thor. Boy, Frank 1 is just ridiculous.
Yeah, I am a little worried that Marvel's Capcom Infinite is going to have Frank West, but it's going to have new Frank West.
Oh, yeah? Well, it's funny because the fact that they're putting out a new Marvel vs. Capcom game, I feel like is kind of interesting considering Capcom hasn't had a new game in years or anything with like a new character in it. Like,
you mean Street Fighter V?
Street Fighter V doesn't really count. They'll just, I mean, I don't know. What'll
It doesn't because it has new characters in it.
No, it doesn't count. Doesn't count.
Just why not?
Because there's like 600 characters in that game. And yeah, there's a few new characters, but that's like one character. Oops.
No, not rematch.
There's like 5 or 6 new characters. Like
no, but that one of them will probably make its way into Marvel vs. Capcom. What I'm saying is that Capcom has not been like creating new IPs for the last several years. They've just been putting out like HD remakes and sequels and stuff like that. And I don't know. I mean, I guess I can still bank on the nostalgia. God only knows they've done it before. Ooh, yeah. Let's see. Like Hagar. Oh, I do not like that ponytail one little bit. Let's see. And how about Amaterasu from Okami? It's good. Alex says Mighty No. 9 has appeared in a lot of the worst game lists of 2016.
Yeah, it has.
Yeah. I never bothered after we played it. I think you and I played it, right?
Yeah.
We played the full version when it came out. It just didn't seem like all that compelling of a game. So. Is that Taskmaster saying
yes,
that?
Yes, it is.
Is he a cheesy character?
No.
Okay. Because that was kind of a cheesy line. Oh, goddamn. I need to stop accidentally popping that. Rawr, take a bunch of lions and birds and shit. Oh, well, that was bad. Bad timing.
Yeah, Scarlet Spider. Finn Riley. Kicking ass.
Oh, shit. All right. Mike Hagar.
Mustache.
Oh, no, not the Incredible Hulk. Mike
Planet
Hagar's
Hulk on top of that.
One weakness. Eat fucking metal pipe, Hulk. Okay, all right.
Wow. The green really glows in the black and white.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Ooh, what the hell move was that? Oh, boo. Ah, crapola. Damn it. That's not what I was trying to do.
Oh, there we go.
Someone in the chat apparently thinks that we don't even know how to play.
Really?
And I would say yes.
Yes. Yep. Don't know shit about playing this game. That's true. Yep. Very, very true.
Very good observation.
Absolutely. You must be new here. Thank you very much for stopping by. I'm not even going to pretend. I'm not going to like try to front. Like, oh, my God,
oh,
no.
No, man. We play this game all day, every day. You just don't understand the complexity of our finger movements
right
now.
Yep. That's very true. No idea how to fucking play this game.
I have an off-kilter style. It's to throw my opponents off. In that I play the game very badly.
Yeah.
He's literally just smashing his hand against the controller.
Yeah.
Like if he were clapping.
Not even my hand. It was just my face. I'm smashing the controller into my face as hard as possible.
I honestly thought that was going to turn into a dick joke. But
yeah, I'm not trying to beat up on the guy or anything. It's just, yeah, we don't know how to play. Just thought we'd have some fun and play this game.
Yeah, this is a lot casual...
So
coming back. Well, that's nice.
I won one.
There you go.
Take that, Frank West.
Didn't you win the last one, too?
No.
Oh.
Did he? Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I?
Yeah, that's why I handed it over.
Oh. No, you won the last one.
No, I got KO'd. I got knocked out. All my characters got knocked out.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm fucking positive.
Let's play some Street Fighter. Full Street Fighter characters here.
Nice. Pick one group. John.
One group?
Because he's doing just Street Fighter. You got to pick.
Oh.
You got to make a group happen here.
Like just Marvel? OG Pred 1, you're going to kick our asses. I mean, is that what you want? You just like really want to get on the stream? and whoop our asses. I'm not even gonna say
fight me, noob. We're like, all right.
Well, there's no chance we'll win. Like, there's like, if you're here and you could watch us play and you know that we're bad, yeah, of course you're better. You probably like this game and play it all the time.
Dr. Von Boogie wanted the defenders, but I don't think that's possible.
So I just concede now. Why even bother? Like, you'll just come in here. You'll do the screen will fill up with lights and colors and sounds and screaming. And then we'll be dead.
And Jeff's tears.
And my tears, right.
I went with villains.
Why?
Yeah, we are going to be playing online later. I mean, add me on your friends list and rage select. And after the break, we'll be playing online.
I'll meet you behind the fucking bleachers. Let's do this. I'll fucking fight you right now.
Amanda means it in IRL, by the way.
Yeah, I'll take you. Let's do it. Dark Paul is playing some goldfish.
Playing
is it
some
goldfish or go fish? Because I used to call it go fish.
Go fish is what
it says. Got any sevens? I play a mean goldfish. But isn't it go fish? Because then you're sending people to fish for more cards.
Yeah, you tell them to go fish.
Dang, Dark Paul, you don't even know what the fuck you're talking.
Wow. Amanda.
Amanda said, you don't want to be on the stream when it's time for, you don't want to be on the stream when Amanda gets competitive. Oh, shit.
Is the gamer tag if they need to send friend requests?
It's Rage Select.
It's Rage Select.
Yeah.
It's on the top of the thing, bro.
Yeah.
Do it. Fight me.
Fight me! You'll win! I suck! Yeah,
see how far this butt mash takes me. Not very, but we'll see.
You'll come on, I won't even be able to do a single move. You'll probably get a perfect. Prepare for me to be annihilated. Yes! I mean, like, whatever. I don't. Oh, shit. I don't even know what that meant. I don't even know how to do the moves. I don't even know how to do half the moves. I don't have any idea what the fuck I'm even doing.
Looking at the controller like, I don't even know what I'm pushing. I don't even know anymore.
He's like, y'all about to get fucked up. You're right. That's true. I'm not going to sit here and talk shit.
So is this person a bot?
No.
Finds people that are playing this game and then tells them how much they're going to beat them?
Just somebody who came onto Twitch and saw us playing this, and they're like, these guys suck at this game. And I'm just saying, that's true.
Gladly admit it.
Somebody's a shit talker, but they don't know what to do when the other person agrees. Like, you're a piece of shit. Yeah, man.
Yep, total piece of shit.
Oh, man, it's embarrassing.
I agree. I shouldn't even be allowed to play this game. Like, they should just refund me the money and shut down the stream.
Ooh,
right
I
now.
I know what I do.
All right, so I got all Devil May Cry.
You look like you hurt Marvel.
Sure.
That's probably true.
That's cool. I mean, you know. I'll call the guy with the gun to your head making you watch this stream if you want. Let you go home. But
send him home. We're not converting this one today.
I don't care. Like, you can talk all the whoa, dude.
Whoa, I didn't know we were taking this shit seriously. Bringing the nemesis. There can be only
one winner. All right. No one will stand in my way.
I'm the second best at what I do.
What?
That's Scarlet Spider.
No, but why'd she say I'm the second best at what I do?
Because Wolverine's the best.
Number one.
She's a clone of Wolverine.
Okay, well, but have a little, you know, have a little.
Yeah, way to put women back a step, X-23.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Wolverine's going to die, and then she becomes Wolverine.
Oh, shit.
Oh, she can only become Wolverine if man's out of the way. Is that
pretty
how
much.
It is?
She does beat up Sabretooth, though.
I mean, who doesn't?
Yeah, Sabretooth's kind of a punk.
Oop. There's like a whole mythology of a goldfish tournament going on in the chat, by the way.
Oh, yeah?
They're like, oh, yeah, I was in the national team for the U.S. goldfish.
For goldfish? For the mythical sport
of... We were the mighty fishes.
Of goldfish.
I was trying to go for a specific theme for my characters.
Yeah.
But I couldn't figure out who to do for the third one, so I just went with...
Clone, Horrible Clone Mutant.
Yeah.
That's my favorite card game is Clone Clone Mutant. Oh, shitty. All right.
You're gonna die. Oh, wow. Wow.
Ah, shitty. What? Okay. Trying to just like, can I just do a thing, anything?
Like, his gun is so high up because of how tall he is that if I'm just standing and you're just standing, the missile goes right over you.
Nice.
Oh. I think if I were to be Nemesis, and someone were to be like Beautiful Joe or Rocket Raccoon,
you
it'd be like the worst fight ever.
Oh, shit.
I'd take that bet. Let's do it.
It's going to kill me. Oh, shit. Okay.
That was,
there we go.
A kick to the fucking shins. Can't fight that. You can't fight shins. Shin kicks, man. Woo!
You don't play
good
Amanda?
Good job with
here,
that.
Someone else
okay,
take
I'll
the controller
just play
for
myself
me.
Then. Just me fighting. Why does she have boob zippers?
Because why not? Zippers are all the rage.
Needs to nurse, obviously.
She does not need to nurse.
She does not need to nurse. All right, let me see. Who haven't we played in here? About Super Scroll and Phoenix and
yeah, let's do that.
Felicia, Dormammu. There we go.
Finally, Dormammu.
Super Scroll, Phoenix, and Dormammu. Bad guys. There you go.
Ugh. I want her to wear a really nice hat. I don't know who else. Let's do this. Fucking
jeez.
With the shit outfits. There, they match. They're all in red. Good. I planned it because I'm a girl. Their outfits.
They all match.
Look, they're all wearing red.
Okay.
Cute. Oh, yeah, they all match.
All Christmas-y. My characters have fire on them.
Neat. No.
Super Skull has fire. He's just not doing it right now.
Because he doesn't feel like it.
I don't feel like it. I could totally do fire. See?
There's
See?
Fire.
There's fire. Damn it, Felicia. Throw in that ball of yarn. God damn it. Did I trigger that?
What the fuck is happening, man?
Fucking hell. This is what happens when you jam on
Jesus
all the buttons.
Jesus, noob. You can't get shit straight.
That's true. I can't.
You're going to get wrecked, son.
I am going to get wrecked.
Oh, I sent my character out to get fucking wrecked.
Dormammu, I don't know what all of your buttons do. What?
So, interesting little factoid.
Ooh, neat. Nice.
And this is something I found out. And no one's going to care about this at all.
Stop it.
The voice of Dormammu is a guy who, by an actor by the name of Michael T. Weiss, who is also the lead actor on the TV show The Pretender.
Oh.
Which is a show that I've been watching in... You know, again, recently.
Yes, at least once a year, he goes through that entire.
He's also the voice
series.
Of Jason Blood and Etrigan in Justice League Unlimited and Batman the Animated Series.
Oh.
Boom. Drop some knowledge on you.
What was all this information when we were asking for.
Fucking Dormammu was not on my screen to remind me of that little piece of knowledge.
What?
Oh, no.
You're going to get hit. I'm going to hit you
not
so
only
hard.
That, the other day, like the last episode of The Pretender that I've watched in my rewatching of the entire series was actually the one where he discovered about Spider-Man.
Well, there you go. What?
I didn't mean to do that again, but, you know.
You know, so.
Uh-oh.
Why are you?
I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I apologize. It's the worst. Look away, children. Don't learn this. No, I don't know what's going on. I don't know how this thing works. Jane, get me off this crazy thing. Okay. How do I? I was just trying to do that thing.
This is the best.
Bye, Pred. Here, hold this for a second.
There you go.
I did
your job for you.
Thank you. All right.
Now you all know. John beats me.
Yep. Oh, dude, I should have done that the whole time.
Why weren't you doing it the whole time,
I don't
huh?
even know what it is or how to do it.
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh,
here you go, John. You can have that back.
No, good.
Keep going?
Yeah, you can keep going.
Okay.
That's a win for me, motherfucker.
All right.
Sorry, I was...
Okay. I don't know. I feel like a couple more here, and then we'll probably open this up. Open it up to the world.
Open this pit up.
Yeah.
You motherfuckers want to play?
And then you guys can watch us just get fully wrecked. Just wrecked entirely for another, like, what, hour and 45 minutes or something. Oh, yeah. I forgot about Shuma Gorath.
Man, these are some ugly fucking costumes. Who wants any of these costumes? Just solid Iron Man. No one else, nothing.
Yeah,
nothing.
McMillan, I don't care unless people start fucking with my co-hosts, and then I do care. So that's the
rules.
Oh, I don't care that you don't care.
Okay.
Oh, did they
See,
say something
mean
about
caring all the way around.
Based on what I was saying about pointing out the voice actor.
Yeah.
He was like, oh my God, no one fucking cares. Shut the fuck up.
Don't care.
And I don't care about that. It's like, whatever.
That hurts my feelings.
Red Hulk?
Yeah.
I'm literally going to go through all these costumes.
Hulk.
I hope you're all prepped.
Green Hulk.
I hope you're all prepped for me wanting to pick the right outfits for everybody. I'm sorry. Yeah, a little bit.
All right.
One time, I was playing Go Fish, and I got blackjack.
That picture, the little card of the, what's his name? Shuma Gora?
Uh-huh.
It's just, he looks like he's hands on his hips like, oh, you. It's great. I love it.
I've got a pretty ridiculous team here outside of, like, I like to wonder if Sea Viper is like, what am I doing here? What is going on here? I got a little demon. I got a little demon and then like a Cthulhu man and like, Shuma Gorath. I'm hard to defend against. When the computer plays me, Jeff isn't good.
Yeah, that's the only time Jeff isn't good.
Have eyeballs. All eyeballs for everybody. Wee. Blarg, 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 blarg. Oh, jammin.
Hope you like jammin too.
Damn it. Oh no, Chun-Li, get out of here. How about, where's my, where's Sea Viper at? There we go.
Oh, little girl on girl action. I won't give you the pleasure.
Woo! Uh-oh. I don't even know how to throw in this game.
I don't know what I did.
That's how bad I am. Oh, shit.
Ask me what buttons I'm pushing.
Oh, look, I activated my X again. Great.
I don't know what that does.
I'm supposed to go to Evo later this year to play this game against people in tournament. I hope I win.
How is that not killing you? Fuck.
It almost killed me. There you go.
Almost means jack shit in this game.
Almost is for Dark Souls and your mom.
Coffee is for closers, Jeff. You know this.
There's a quote from Vin Diesel from the movie Fast and the Furious that I don't remember. It's all about almost winning.
What just happened?
You should remember that.
You just did your ultimate, like, right over my head. It was awesome. It was like I just stood there.
I'm like, hope this guy isn't too short for this. And then I shot over your fucking head.
Uh-oh. Air combos. Wait, you have the Hulk the whole time?
Yeah, man.
Oh.
What, am I going to not save him till the end?
Like, where the fuck has the Hulk been?
Hiding.
Chilling.
Yeah.
Just chilling.
Drinking
in
some coffee.
Ha!
He's here now.
Oh, shit. It's the Hulk. It's the Hulk. I'm full of insanity and tiny little spiky balls.
I can't tell if you're talking about the character you're playing or yourself.
Both. Really.
So.
Whoop. Dr. Von Boogie, I'm going to have a great time playing this fighting game right up until right now when we go online and
play against people online.
Play against people online. So. Jeez, Louise.
Wow. He's horrifying. There you go.
All right. So it's time to go online. And let's see. John, I feel like we should pass this around because
I think it should just be exclusively Jeff playing on.
Yeah, matter of fact, I'm going to use a restroom.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
I'll be right back.
Play your, put your rank online. Enjoy battling out with players in matches that do not affect your rank. Custom match. Search for a match.
Can we customize a match so that we never lose?
No. I feel like the other players that play... Have you ever watched anybody play this game competitively?
Oh, yeah. It's horrifying.
It's insane. Yeah. Like, I feel like we could put it on... Like, where we had... Where our handicap was all the way up. And it would... it wouldn't matter. It really wouldn't.
Yeah.
All right. I'm just going to pick Iron Man and Wolverine and...
There was a Sentinel here the whole time, and I didn't
pick
him.
Oh, yeah, we never played the Sentinel. All right. I don't even know what the net code in this is like.
Patrick. Patrick Chen. Go on. Pick your players.
He's picking.
Pick him.
He's picking them.
Pick him faster.
He's got to decide. He's got to think about what he wants to do.
Epic Gamer says robot.
Look at those little Destructoid heads.
Yeah, those are okay. Cool. It's a good design.
I guess we're double blind, or maybe he can see who I played, but I can't see who he played. I'm gonna try. Like, I'm not just gonna like fuck around.
Oh yeah,
man. I'm actually gonna
try. Do not. There is no try, bro.
But I know that it's gonna be bad.
Yeah.
So I just want everybody to be ready.
See, we never lose. We either win or we learn something.
Yeah.
So really, there's no losing.
There is no losing.
Yeah. And what we learn is we shouldn't be playing this game.
Yeah.
Oh.
I mean, I actually kind of know how to play this guy a
little
bit.
I mean, in fairness, he...
Wait, why is this... God damn, this is fucking slow as shit.
There you go.
Oh, damn! No, he's just letting me do stuff.
Who's dressed up as the Wolverpool?
Wolverpool?
The Wawa?
Wolverine Deadpool.
Oh. Uh-huh. Okay. I mean, all I've got is cheese dicking, bro, so I'm sorry. Oh, shit. Did I actually kill his Deadpool?
Yes. He also
How about
your
Spider-Man? This is like super janky and slow.
Yeah,
all my co-hosts going to the bathroom.
Hey.
Trying to play video games here.
Well, we'd like to play the video games too, but we can't do it while we gotta pee.
Okay, that's true. Wait a minute. Am I winning like crazy? Is this because I'm new?
Yeah.
Is this because
you're both
I'm
beginners?
Like, fighting?
You're both beginner ranks.
Oh, okay.
So you're fighting other noobs.
Okay. Well, that makes a certain amount of sense, because I have not even switched off of frickin' Iron Man yet. Reversal! Oh, no!
Dr. Von Boogie wants to know, after they do Infinity War, are there any characters that the Marvel Cinematic Universe should bring in?
Yeah.
He thinks that because of how disappointing the Superman movies have been as of recent, that Marvel should do a Century movie. I think that they should not do that, personally.
Wait, because of how... I'm sorry, how...
Because
mediocre...
DC has been doing mediocre with Superman.
Uh-huh.
Marvel should show them up by doing Century, which is essentially a ripoff of Superman.
Oh.
I don't know if you know who the character of the Century is.
I read the original series where they established him, but that was it. So
yeah.
I never did much outside of that. So all I knew was that original thing, and I like that story. But I'm going to just create a lobby for us. Lobby size 8. Region,
but
rank,
you know, as far as characters, I want them to do in the cinematic universe that they have not touched yet. I don't know. I mean, we're getting an Iron Fist TV series.
Yeah.
We got, you know, I wouldn't mind seeing Hawkeye get his own solo movie.
All right. So now I have a lobby. We're going to wait, see if anybody gets into the lobby. Sorry. I'm just trying to.
No, I understand. I'm trying to think of what other characters would I like to see that are.
Is anybody actually playing this game?
Probably not.
Tales from the Borderlands, Day of the Tentacle, Dragon Age Inquisition, Overwatch, Dishonored, SteamWorld Heist, Skyrim, WWE 2K17. Jace is not playing anything. Resident Evil 4. I was just trying to see if anybody's actually playing.
Yeah, I wouldn't
this
mind
game.
Seeing a Marvel Hercules movie or Runaways. Though I heard that they were doing Runaways as a miniseries, like a TV miniseries or something, or I don't know.
Invitations? There are no invitations.
Yeah,
I think Hercules would only work as a television series if we're talking about Marvel's Hercules.
Yeah, well, the question was, after they get done with the Infinity War thing, what character would you like to see introduced next into the Marvel Cinematic Universe? Like, what characters would be a good
mother
fit.
Fucking She-Hulk, for fuck sake, or Spider-Woman, because they're both goddamn amazing.
Yeah, I can see that.
I'm tired of waiting. I'm just gonna go fight individual fights.
I want a Squirrel Girl cartoon series.
A bit of ranked match.
Like that's the thing. I want a Disney Channel Squirrel Girl cartoon, unbeatable Squirrel Girl cartoon series.
I don't know anything about the comics these days, so I actually am kind of surprised that when I look at the listing of all the Marvel movies that they have lined up, that I would actually like to see a Hulk movie, but they don't seem to have really that
have
much interest in doing that.
Bad luck with Hulk movies.
Yeah. I mean, I actually went back and rewatched the Edward Norton Hulk, and it wasn't as bad.
I actually like the Edward Norton
Hulk. Yeah, I really fought
for the biggest
one.
Problem with the Edward Norton Hulk is the fact that it was Edward Norton, which I don't even know if he was the biggest problem, but he's the biggest problem for Marvel.
Yeah.
He was a big problem because he wanted way too much creative control for a Marvel movie. Because he really wanted to do what he wanted with that character, and that's all well and good, but that's not how that works.
Yeah. Okay, how about just a regular match? Is that where everything is?
But yeah, I'm trying to think of like what kind of characters.
I don't know,
because I mean they kind of hit all the characters like in either Netflix TV shows or whatever. They've kind of hit all of the major ones that I would want.
It really depends. I mean, are they gonna do Kamala Khan in a Marvel Cinematic Universe or a televised universe at all?
I would almost want that to be like a TV series.
If I could get a television series that was Ms. Marvel, Kamala Khan's Ms. Marvel, Miles Morales' Spider-Man, and Nova. Nova?
Oh, yeah. So basically do the
three young Avengers?
The new champions.
Yeah, the new champ. If I could get a television series that was that, I'd be happy as fuck. And not make them too old, because I feel like when you put them in a TV series, people have instinct to make them young 20s instead of like 15.
Yeah. You know who else I would actually wouldn't mind? I wouldn't mind seeing a young Avengers movie. You know, now that we've got like, what is it? Like there's going to be three Avengers movies, four technically. We should get like a young Avengers movie about the young Avengers. Patriot, Stature, what the fuck was this? Characters' names. Asgardian.
Asgardian. Is his name still Asgardian?
I think he might. It may be
Oh my god, Wiccan. Wiccan online sucks nuts.
Yeah, it does. Dark Devil 2011
says.
Oh
my good lord!
Oh man.
I wonder if he'll have time to block this or dodge it, you guys.
Yeah. I would love Moon Knight. I totally would love Moon Knight. And I'm actually kind of upset that. Apparently,
I beat up his Jean Grey a little bit.
Before pitching Guardians of the Galaxy, apparently.
Wait, how am I winning?
Oh God, why can't I think of his name all of a sudden? Who directed Guardians of the Galaxy?
James Gunn.
Apparently, he had pitched a Moon Knight movie to Marvel. And they actually apparently really liked it, but then they wanted him to do Guardians of the Galaxy first and then also do Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Yeah.
And he's got a few other movies lined up, so he's like, okay, well, I'm never going to be able to make this movie, but here's my idea if you want to hand it to somebody else to do it, if you like it so much, feel free.
Yeah.
I'm
still interested in seeing an Edgar Wright-directed comic book movie that's not Scott Pilgrim. Like action-based one and not a whatever Scott Pilgrim was.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I don't know why.
Blue blazes.
I don't know why this is happening.
Sweet Christmas.
This is weird. I don't understand.
Excelsior.
All right. Great.
Yay.
I'm going to exit this match.
Oh, he's like, rematch? And you're like, fucking
dude,
no.
The lag was incredible. It was like playing a turn-based strategy game.
WTF. Everyone else is also shocked that you won.
I'm just not. I mean, I've tried playing a ranked match, but it was just searching for too long.
Is Jeff getting good?
Not good. Not good. Bad. Getting worse. That guy, like, knew how to do stuff, though. Did you see that? Like, he put me in, like, an air juggle and, like, took off, yeah, like, 3/4 of my health and shit?
Yeah.
Is this the same guy that we were just calling?
No. Konohita said, use a play it, Jeff.
Oh, shit.
Also, Dark Devil apparently hated Scott Pilgrim.
Eh. Aw, boo.
I enjoyed it.
I really liked the movie, but, you know, that's just me. OMG, Jeff is gat good. Gid. Gat gid.
Johnny Gat good.
Iron Man. Iron Man.
Iron Man?
Iron Man.
Iron Man. Can you play
Iron Man?
Can you play the same
character? Iron Man.
Can you play the same character over and over again?
Yes.
It'd be amazing.
I actually kind of know a little bit how to play Iron Man. So that's like I'm sticking to the characters that I kind of know how to play. No, this is the same guy. This is the same guy. Yeah, it's the exact same guy. He's playing the exact same team he was playing before.
Yeah. See? It's awkward. Would you want Saga to be a video game, since the creator doesn't want to do a TV series or movie? Ah! Bless that creator. Who is it? Who
Brian K. Vaughan?
Brian K. Vaughan. What a magical human being. To not automatically want to throw his shit into the goddamn movies and TV.
Well, that's
this
the
guy's
thing.
So angry. He's so angry.
Well, that's the thing about Brian K. Vaughan, is he writes comics because he wants to write comics.
Yeah, unlike, what's his goddamn name, Mark Millar?
Yeah.
Fuck that dude.
Who only writes comics so he can get them turned into movies.
Yeah,
and is very open about it.
When I worked at a comic book shop known as Rogues Gallery Comics and Games in Round Rock, Texas. What was that, Jeff? You want to hear it again? Rogues Gallery Comics and Games in Round Rock, Texas.
Oh, yeah?
People would always ask me if I've like read the latest Mark Millar comic, and I always told them no, because it's not worth my fucking time, because, one, it's going to be made into a movie, and two, he's not going to finish it before the fucking movie's out anyway.
Yeah. Also, the movie's going to be completely different from the comic, so why do I care?
It sounds like she keeps saying top this.
She might be.
Top that, bitch.
Let's get Wolverine up in
here.
Is
there a fucking... is that a piranha plant in the background?
Yes, from...
Ghouls and Goblins?
Ghouls and Goblins, yeah, where Ghosts Arthur is from.
It's Ghosts and Goblins and Ghouls and Ghosts.
Did it look like that? Because that looks fun.
Yeah.
I never
That's
played
cool,
it.
Bro. You're so much better than
yeah,
I
am. Yeah, it was 2D.
Great, wonderful. Huzzah.
Is Why the Last Man being made into a movie, TV series
or something? They keep trying.
Yeah. Also, I think Why the Last Man has run its course as far as comics.
Yeah.
Because it's just been...
Well, Why the Last Man's over.
Yeah, I know. It's just, it's been a while. Like, yeah, it's been out for a long time. So, like, most people that would read it as a comic have already read it as a comic.
True.
So now you can go and make it into a movie or a TV. Now yeah. I'll backtrack so it doesn't seem like I hate everyone that wants their stuff to be a movie or television.
Dave C. 741, yes, I have read the Moon Knight comic.
I've read, I think, the first trade for it, but I haven't
yeah,
read the,
I read, I read the Brian K. Vaughan series and on, and then I also read the first couple of issues of the newest
the
Moon Knight
Lunatic?
Run. Yeah, the Looney Bin one.
Oh my god, the art in it is fucking beautiful.
Oh yeah, it's
I want
great.
One of the pages they have, I want as a tattoo, so... And my brother loves Moon Knight, so I figure it'll be a brother tribute tattoo.
Did the Warren Ellis Moon Knight?
Warren Ellis did do a run on Moon Knight. He kind of weirdly turned him into his character from Planetary, the main character from Planetary.
Mm, okay.
Which was kind of weird. Well, like it was like a superhero version of that guy,
okay.
But like it was just weird. But I liked it. It was pretty good.
Ooh, Gohan Trunks won. I bet this guy knows exactly what he's doing. It's going to whoop the floor with my butthole.
I don't know what you said, but it sounded like whip my throat with some butter.
It was whoop the floor with my butthole, actually. But, you know, whatever you feel like. Oh, does Deadpool have a cable costume on?
There's very possible. Yes, yes, he does. They all have white hair, spiky hair. This guy has coordinated his hair for all his characters. Why is he dressed like that?
Kind of silly.
Who, Deadpool?
Yeah. Yeah.
He's dressed like Cable.
I know, but why? I don't need to know.
Because he loves Cable. He's secretly in love with him. And
have
not
you heard
so secretly.
This weird shit about Ryan Reynolds trying to petition for
Hugh Jackman to
Deadpool
do a...
to be, have a romantic interest?
Male
romantic interest?
Yeah.
Yeah! Oh, this guy's higher level than I am.
I think people are misunderstanding Deadpool's willingness to fuck anything with bisexuality, which is not the same thing.
Okay. So this is what I've been expecting the entire time of playing this game, is just like, I don't understand how to do anything, and so the game just whoops my ass all the livelong day until we're done, until I lose, and then it's great.
The chat apparently has caught up with the conversation about whipping buttholes, and now all of them are like, now I just can't stop thinking about Jeff's butthole.
Don't think about my butthole. That's a bad move, buddy.
That and your dank worms.
Don't think about both of them at the same time, that's for sure, because one will lead you to a place that you do not want to be. Trust in me.
The other one is...
Think about one or the other, but not both. Whatever you do.
One of them will lead you to a place you don't want to be, and the other one's his butthole.
The other one's my butthole. It's true.
What the fuck?
Bam.
There's no winning in this conversation, Jeff.
Uh-oh. Well, at least I'm up in the air. Oh, shit.
But yes, Deadpool is pansexual. Though he does have a wife, but she's a demon, so take that for what
they've been having some marital issues the last I read.
Yeah, that's true.
Deadpool's been in love with many a bitch.
Yeah, he's also got a daughter, so, you know.
Yeah! I don't know who the mom of his kid is.
Damn, how did... This guy was, like, whooping my shit up. He, like, smacked my bitch up, and
Dr.
now...
Dr. Von Boogie is confused because he thought Jeff's dank worm pit was his butthole.
Oh, no. No. It's a whole other thing. Trust me.
That's confusing.
Well, what the fuck, man? That guy was whooping my butthole. I mean, my worm pit. I mean, my wormhole. I don't know. My dank wormhole.
Oh, man.
That's how I get to the Alpha Quadrant, all right? Through the dankest of dank wormholes. Okay.
I don't want to go to work, but I don't want to stay here either. Now I'm just really, really conflicted.
I didn't. PTFT show. I never bothered finishing Final Fantasy 15. I mean, I may go back, but goddamn, it's a chore to play that game.
I never played it.
Like I hate the characters so
much. I want to play it. I actually still want to play it. You know, but I also refuse to play it. You know, when it's incomplete.
Yeah. So you're gonna wait for the Game of the Year edition plus all of the updates?
Probably,
because apparently that thing that I was complaining about. Well, you were there. We read that thing was like part of the DLC. All right.
Professor Thorgy says the word you are looking for, Jeff, is Sarlacc pit.
Wait, so Jeff's butthole is called a Sarlacc pit? Is that what you're saying?
That is where Boba Fett had disappeared to.
JeffsDankSarlacc.com. For all of your dank Sarlacc needs. Oh, this is this guy's rank up battle where he goes from beginner to not beginner anymore. And I'm gonna try to fuck it all up.
Jeff's pit and his pendulum.
Oh, God, it's so slow.
Hey, Darkpaul 90, you missed talk of Jeff's dank wormhole and his Sarlacc pit
so
and
slow.
His butthole all at the same time.
So,
but they're all different.
Yeah, all different things, but they're all the same thing.
Star Punch asks, what comic creator would you want to have a biopic movie about? I want a movie about Rob Liefeld on how he destroyed comics.
He didn't destroy comics. Come on, let's not be...
He just destroyed a lot of people's idea of what art is.
So
no, I don't even think he did that. I think he just... Okay, here's the thing. I don't like Rob Liefeld's art. I also think he's a pompous ass as a person.
Here we go.
But
finally, I found somebody that knows how to play this game like an insane person. Why are you a beginner?
But having said that, I do feel like sometimes, people harp on him a little bit too much, like undeservedly. Just because the man learned how to draw worse over time does not mean,
Nope.
He started off decent and then progressed downward. at the end of his career. It's great. Like, I've gone to his website,
yeah,
and he has a gallery of just, like, all of his art. Mm-hmm. And, like, you can start at, like, the stuff now, and if you start going backwards, it looks like he's getting better.
Yeah, nice. That's sad, actually. I mean, if we're talking about real-life creators that are good that we want to know.
I want fucking Jack Kirby, man. Give me some Jack Kirby biopic stuff.
Are they doing a Stan Lee biopic after all?
Apparently they're doing a Stan Lee fictional biopic.
Well, I mean, if they don't have every superhero make a fucking cameo in a Stan Lee biopic, then I'm not watching it.
From what I've heard is that it's Stan Lee, but it's like he's like it's almost like a trying to think of a way to explain it. It's like if Stan Lee's life were in a comic book, like how he would.
I refuse to believe his life was not in a comic book.
Well, true. But like it's interesting how it.
I hope Miart regresses.
Oh, I got a new title.
Tony Heath wrote it like she was a pirate. So.
So.
Okay. I'm just gonna keep playing ranked matches.
Again. So
yeah, ranked.
I had no idea how to stop. That's the thing I don't like about playing this game is that.
But you chose this.
I know.
Game.
I know.
The blame is on you.
I know. No, I. It's
I want to play games where we cook food and bitches' clothes come off. But no.
No, it's fine. it's this game. There's nothing wrong with this game. It's just that like. Whenever anybody talks about me playing this game, it's like, oh, you're so bad at it. It's not like, well, what buttons would you use to get... I mean, is there like a combo breaker or something that you can use when you're getting like juggled into like a 16 million hit combo? Or is it just like the first time that shit happens, you should just set the controller down for 20 minutes because the person who's rocking your world knows more about this game than you do? I mean, that's a question.
You're not doing terribly bad, though.
Well, in the last one I was. But it was because that guy knew how to do... That's what I don't really understand is when you play somebody and they know how to do this thing where, like, it seems like you have no possible way to exit the combo. That it's just a 1 billion hit combo.
What does it mean if they're ninth lord?
I don't have any idea.
That's the most intimidating thing I've seen.
That's one of the ranks. Yeah.
Yeah. He has ninth lord and 3 stars underneath.
Yep. No, it means that he's, like, so good that it should be against the law what's about to happen here.
You mean you beating him?
Jesus Christ, I don't know how the fuck that's happening. He's ninth lord already! Come on!
Is that like being the ninth doctor?
I don't know.
Eccleston.
I put Captain America in at exactly the wrong time.
Swiss cheese! Delicious!
So, like, right about here, this is the part where I don't know what to do at this point. Okay, so, like, I managed to get out of that, but, like, that last guy, he was doing that, and then he would do, like, another thing, and then he would do, like, a third thing, and then it was, like, by the time he was done, I was just, like, had no health left. Okay! What? It also would help if I actually knew what any of these characters did. Like, any of the moves... And not just Swiss cheese, and like bringing in Captain America just to get punched in the face.
Jesus. This is how I win. This is how I became Ninth Lord.
No, this is fully on my fault, man. It's not my fault that I don't know how to even just get out of just some standard bullshit Ryu's going to throw fireballs at you. That's like the baby day of fighting games. If I'm getting beat up by that, that's full on and complete my fault.
D-Hood says he likes a Swiss cheese combo with pastrami.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We already had lunch, though, so.
Yeah.
You got to answer him. He's asking, are you Ken?
What?
Are you Ken?
Oh.
I made a joke.
Unibeam. Yes. Yes.
See, that's how you get around that. Is you do that, and then you get a 15-hit combo that...
That was like 9 hits. Don't over exaggerate. Oh, shit.
Good lord.
Oh, now who's got the 35 hit combo, you fucking cheater?
He does.
Oh, shit. Still. Oh, no. Hit the back button, bro. Oh.
Player All right. Oh, you're so peaceful, Ryu.
I do appreciate Dark Devil 2011. You didn't suck, Jeff. It was the game's fault.
Yeah, the game was cheating. No, I fully understand that I suck. It's just I don't. It's not that I suck that is the problem. It's the judgment that comes from people who play this game a lot about, like, oh, you suck. It's like, it's that for every single game in the world where you suck at a game and people are more interested in telling you how bad you are than trying to, like, help you get better or anything. Like, I don't think I've ever actually, like, I don't think I've ever harangued, like, you for playing Bloodborne or Dark Souls or anything like that, except maybe in the most joking of fashions. But
you got really upset at me when I was playing Metal Gear Solid terribly.
He was coming home crying, Jeff.
Yes. Well, that's true. That is true. That was because we needed to progress, and we can't spend a 145-minute video killing the same boss over and over again.
I'm just saying.
Konohita said, you're not out of touch, Jeff. It's the children.
Oh, it's the children.
Going back to Jeff's butthole.
Oh, good.
Jeff's butthole making a
2017
cameo on the Misadventures of Shitman video? What the fuck?
I don't know what that is. Please don't look it up. Please don't look it up.
I'm not.
Okay.
I'm not into that kind of stuff.
I don't want that in my browser history.
That's how you get on lists.
Ambu Swaggin, this is on the PS4, actually. Dark Souls. Xbox has Dark Souls 2 for $15. Is it worth it? I mean, if you don't have a PC or a current gen console, I don't feel like it's worth it. If you do, let me just change it up a little bit here. Ambu Swaggin, I don't know how to do that. Like, I'm just, did you send me like an invite or something? Or like, I started up a room and nobody came into it. But I'd be more than happy to let anybody in the chat room who wants to kick my ass all the live long day, because that's part of what this stream is here for. But I just have to know how. Just tell me, explain to me how I do that.
Air combo.
Oh, I don't have any things. Okay. Good Lord. Good Lord. Hey, I'm an amateur now.
Yeah.
That was pretty fast. I've been losing for the last, like, three rounds. How do I get...
You're getting good. Yeah, I mean, you're not getting great, but, you know.
Passable. Passable is really where
it's amateur.
At.
You know.
Yeah.
It's amateur hour.
Okay.
Yeah. Fucking clown shoes, Jeff.
I don't know how to do that one either, how you do the air combo thing. I just don't ever seem to be able to get the timing on it correct.
God damn.
Yep. Oops. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit.
Rock.
Yep.
Is it the other guy? Cuz I don't think it's the other guy.
I got one tiny little sliver of health left and he's going to take it away. He's going to take my sliver, y'all. Come on, just let me get rid of that one Wolverine. Let me chip damage Wolverine. Oh, god damn you. Fuck you. Being all good and shit at this game. Sack of a Balonska.
So, Persona Aiko wants to know, how are you guys' holiday breaks?
Relaxing.
I didn't have a break. I work on the rig.
Okay.
All day, every day. I've been making donuts. Non-stop donuts.
She makes a lot of donuts.
Apparently. All right.
She makes so many donuts that I'm forbidden to eat donuts.
Oh, my goodness. Confirm invitations. Okay, let's see. Maybe this is where I was looking in the wrong
place. I was informed the other day that I now hate donuts.
Oh, look at that. I got some... Well, dude, same... Is that you, Bamboo Swagger?
Yeah, I think it is.
Like, please accept!
All right, great. All right, all right, all right! Yeesh. I thought that other guy totally sent us a thing. Maybe he withdrew it when I banned him. I was willing to fight him. I just didn't want to listen to him be a jerk in the chat room. All right.
Why do you tolerate me being a jerk in the game room?
Because I asked you to be here.
You didn't, though. I just sort of showed up with John.
Because I don't know.
Nice.
Who's that in the upper left-hand corner? Is that Jill Valentine?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Where are you looking?
Next to the word Capcom.
Oh.
Look with her mouth open like, That's
a girl? I thought that was Leon.
No.
Leon. Bum, bum.
All right. All right, bro. You ready to kick my ass? Look, he's a fifth lord. He's the fifth lord of oh my god, he picked all the same people but with better costumes and he knows all the moves and shit. It's gonna make me look like a jerk.
Dr. Von Boogie wants voice chat on.
Fuck you, Dr. Von Boogie. You know that I don't tolerate. What the fuck? Is Iron Man just shooting from off the screen? God damn it. I can't get any of my guys in here. Okay. Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay.
Whoa,
okay.
Whoa,
okay. Okay.
Jeez.
Okay. So I'm going to try something. I'm just going to try blocking for a few minutes and just see if I can not get hit. Not just die. Oh, okay. Well, he got on the other side of me now. And I don't even... They're coming from both sides. I was trying just not to... Okay. All right. So then that happened. And then there was that thing with the giant X. Right? Okay. I tried to attack one time. That didn't work.
Are we 100% sure this isn't the guy that told... That was... trying to beat the shit out of you?
No, but it doesn't really matter because this is what a person who knows how to play this game plays this game like. And
why is the chat debating my race?
What?
What?
Somebody asked if I was black. A new person asked if I was black. And oh. Then somebody said, no, she's Mexican. And then Conejita said, whoa, dude, Amanda is rage American.
A proud rage American.
Somebody said, I thought she was kaleidoscope colored, which is probably the more accurate description.
Yeah, yeah.
Right! Woo!
Right!
Good job, Jeff. You showed them.
I'm here for the enjoyment of everybody. Like, do you guys... I'm going to start making this new channel where it starts out the video where, like, do you need to level up a lot in Marvel vs. Capcom? Do you want to play somebody who's like a baby, doesn't even know what all the buttons do? Well, come on down to the Rage Select channel. Oh, you want to rematch? You want to kick my ass again? Sure. I don't mind. Kick it all day. I don't even know I was blocking, and then I just fucking got smacked around. I don't know. I'm trying to do, like, one attack. I'm trying to wait for him to stop attacking and do, like, one
Well, there's your first mistake.
Okay.
You're waiting.
You know when, when
you, see, I hit him one time! Oh, damn it.
You know when you go to the beach and, like, you go home, like, you spend the whole day at the beach, and then you go home later, and you can still kind of feel the waves of water afterwards, where, like, it feels like the world's kind of moving?
Yeah.
That's how Jeff's going to feel this beating. Just hours,
oh, yeah.
Hours later.
No, you're not kidding. I did a thing. Oh, he did a better thing. Good Lord. I just don't. Nope. Okay. Oh, and then an air throw, and then that thing, and then this thing, and then what? Nope. Can't even stop. Can't stop it. Can't stop the beat. Yep. And now I'm flustered. There is no Dana, only Zool. Right. You guys want to play this guy? John, here, you go for it. You get online.
So we could stop the talk about my race. I look white. So very white, but I am in fact all kinds of Hispanic and Native American, and I got my dad's side apparently has some Japanese in them, and yeah, so I'm all over the place. That's why kaleidoscope skin probably covers it because
There you go.
There. So now you all know, and you're all fans of my race and/or skin color.
There you go. Oh boy. I need like an aspirin.
And Boo Swaggin wants to know what characters people want him to play. Because he's tired of beating the shit out of
I'll
us.
I'll kick your ass with anybody.
Persona Ico, this got awkward. Fast.
Yeah, it did.
Were you not here for the butthole dink worm talk?
Oh, look, she got a lawyer costume. Oh,
that's cute. Did you specifically choose the clothesline because it's a wrestling move?
No, what?
Her moves, it's had her like special and it said clothesline.
Oh, it's... Nah, it's fine.
Your pain will fuel my experiments. What?
All right. Whoa, what the fuck was that giant... It's like a... Like a case of some sort? Like a giant, like, guitar case or something?
I don't know.
Brah, brah, brah! Now, wait a minute. This isn't nearly as much of an ass whooping as I got.
That's just because you suck.
Oh.
Are you sure? Or was it that this guy was playing his mains when he was playing against me and now he's taking it easy on you? With
well, I mean,
oh, yeah,
still
no.
Lost.
Yeah, I mean, I still lost.
Oh.
Yeah, maximum spider.
What does that even mean? Taking the spider to the max.
It's like a spider that drinks, like, Mountain Dew. And, like snowboards
just
and stuff.
She-Hulk just ran past the screen like didn't even help.
Ah! I'm She-Hulk! What are you guys even doing?
No, I'm going to be honest. I know I totally suck.
Every stream we get closer and closer to just being a full-on smut channel. Well, God willing.
Maybe we'd make more money. Get him, She-Hulk! Get her! Is she breathing fire? Oh, that's Phoenix with a Jean Grey skin on.
Whoa.
Oh, She-Hulk's right. Getting rocked.
Yep. I keep wondering, why did it say beautiful? Like, you don't have Beautiful Joe out.
Because. Why not?
No.
You just gotta learn to accept things.
We have to have this conversation.
As many as we can.
When I say why, and then you say, because, why not? That's not an answer.
That's totally an answer.
I need to know a thing.
And I'm explaining the thing.
All right. Are you going to play him again?
Oh, I guess. Well, I guess I am, yeah.
Okay. I mean, I figured this is just going to be us getting our ass kicked no matter what. Or I don't know. Maybe just where you pull out all of your mains and show us how, like, you
used to go
to Evo.
Have you thought about using your mains instead of all the other characters in this game? You know, the ones you're good at. Like, and maybe, nah, I got nothing. Be the
Dr.
Sentinel.
Dr. Sirakis? Resident Evil 7 sucks. There's a walkthrough on Twitch. The game is 5 hours long. Were we talking about Resident Evil? Did I? I know
no.
I don't pay attention all the time. Okay. I mean, I guess thanks or whatever.
Eh, I still plan on playing.
I mean, yeah, if it's 5 hours, five good hours, I don't mind that. I'd spend $60 for 5 hour games before. Oh, goodness.
This game gets 4 out of 5 meat boys.
I don't know. It seems like, you know, to me, Marvel vs. Capcom is almost like the epitome of fighting game, where it requires you to, like, there's no good reason for you to play this game unless you want to just, like, play the shit out of it and get good at it.
Maybe it's like the feeling of when you get that good, how awesome it is. And then when you're that good and then somebody else is that good and you guys are fighting, it feels like a legitimate battle.
Oh, yeah.
But I would rather just learn martial arts at this point than because it's intense, you know?
I think that I honestly feel like this game. Okay, so we played King of Fighters 14 last year, and I really enjoyed King of Fighters 14. You want to know why?
Pourquoi?
There was a 40-step tutorial about how to do every single move and sub-move and combo and whatever in King of Fighters 14 that I could legitimately play all the way through, and it would teach me how to play the game. This game is some typical Capcom bullshit where it's like training mode is just you... And a thing. It's just like it's the computer. It's a computer that doesn't fight back. That's all training mode is. And I've said this before, and I'll say it again. I think that fighting games need to have things for people that are new at them. Like ways to teach them how to play the game so that when you go online and you try to play, it's not just like your screen fills up with fire and mayhem, and then the game over. So...
I like Mortal Kombat because the story mode kind of forces you to learn how to play every character.
Me too. I like Mortal Kombat too because I feel like it's accessible. That, what? Search again then, bro.
They're like, no, nobody's playing.
Nobody's playing this game. Nobody.
Yeah, no, not a single person.
Everyone quit.
They saw me playing. They were like, oh, look out. Jeff's playing.
So, Konohito wants to know, how's the weather in Austin?
Yeah.
Kind of chilly.
It's chilly, and it's supposed to be 80 degrees on Wednesday. So, about as Austin-y as Austin.
It's about a week of winter and then a week of summer. That's pretty much how we.
Yeah.
And we go back and forth.
Yeah. Mortal Wombat. That sounds great. I played that game.
Mortal Wombat!
Dun, 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 dun. I'd watch that movie.
Mortal Wombat?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That could be like a... Oh. Okay.
They're like, oh, shit. It's that rage
that
select.
Oh, you've heard of me, have you? I see. I apologize. I didn't mean to mess up your day. Oh, boy.
Oh, I don't want to go to work.
You
hey,
go to work.
Do any of you guys want to call in my job and call and tell them I died?
Yeah.
Just be like, Amanda... died.
Yeah, if you want to. You can hand me your phone, I'll do that.
No, that's all right.
Amanda's dead.
Amanda's dead, and they're like,
she'll
oh my god.
She'll be back on Monday.
Yeah,
she'll be back tomorrow.
I don't know. What the fuck? I don't work tomorrow. I'm not scheduled.
It'd be like that time that I told Randy that you died.
You read the same thing I did.
I did.
Yep. Somebody said we should play Smash Brothers so everyone can laugh every time I beat Jeff's anus.
I like the way that this today on the Sunday stream that we've gone major anus. That's
No. Major Jeff's anus.
Major Jeff's anus.
Yeah, we haven't even mentioned John's anus.
Not a single time.
Not a single time.
Because I got a sweet ass.
Oh, no. I don't want regular camera. There we go. Try that.
Also, I'm cutting it kind of close.
Do you need to go?
No, I'm going to leave at 4:30.
Okay.
In theory.
We're also going to take a break at 4:30, so.
Yeah, I'm trying to hit, like, halfways. Mm-hmm. And then leave. When you come back, I'll be gone.
There you go.
We got, like, 4 minutes.
One win, three losses.
We've
101 wins, 189 losses.
Nice.
Okay, well, that doesn't help it. Okay. Quit with your bullshit. God damn it.
So, we've got an anal fixation. Jeff's poop hole. I prefer poop shoot.
Yeah, jeffspoopshoot.com.
And sweet John's anus.
Yep.
In your face.
God damn. God damn, I thought that was supposed to be a universal combo. It wasn't.
It was not.
Ooh, in your face.
Dark Devil wants to know when we're going to get a full Jeff's anus sequential Saturday.
What would that be?
I don't want to be a part of that sequential Saturday. That might be a Jeff versus beer.
Is that like what?
Or Jeff versus tacos.
Is that like that don't poop your pants game or whatever? Have you ever seen that game?
No.
It's literally called Don't Shit Your Pants. And it's like kind of an adventure game where the goal is... Like a lot of the things that you do.
Get to the toilet or what?
Yeah, a lot of the things that you do will end up shitting your pants. And so a lot of the things is just trying not to Aha! I did a thing. Uh-oh. Nope, he did a thing. He did a better thing.
Jeff versus Chipotle.
Hey, I got his... No. Come on, man.
That's how you do it, Jeff.
I know. Jeezy.
Do you? Because that's not how you play.
Well, I don't know. Like, I don't have the muscle memory for this game. I don't know anything. It's just fucking lights and colors, and then I die.
From the looks of it, he doesn't have the muscle memory of much. You know what I mean?
Oh! Ouchie. Hurts my feelings.
Jeff's Spelunky. Wait, are we spelunking his anus?
No, they're talking about a game. Downwell.
Is Downwell a game about going down someone's anus?
It's.
Is it about eating the booty?
It is not about eating the booty.
Is it about putting it in the pooper?
Okay, you know what? Can we just have one time? No. Okay.
Oh, that was good.
And that's 4:30, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching the first half of this. We'll be back at 4:45 to watch us get our ass kicked that much more. If you guys send a friend request to Rage Select on the PS4, I'll check them over the break and add anybody who didn't add. I don't want to just play the same person over and over again, so if we can make a room to get a few people in, great. If not, we'll probably just continue doing some rando stuff. So join us back here in 15 minutes, and we will see you then.
Yes.
All right, folks, welcome back to Sunday Streaming. We're playing Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 on the PlayStation 4. John and I are now here by our lonesomes. We're going to do a little fighting before we go back on to the meat grinder that is online. So I want to play some of the bigger characters. We never played Sentinel. We like Hulk, and then like I wanted to play MODOK, but I didn't get a chance, so I'll do that.
Let's see, I'm gonna be Wesker.
Wait a minute, D Hood's eating sausage right now.
Oh shit.
Summer sausage.
Let's see, who should I get?
I don't think we played Wesker before, did we?
No.
We haven't played Jill either. Oh, okay. Does Jill always have to have a little thingy on her chest nowadays? You taking the Resident Evil team?
Yeah, I figure why not. Or no. I don't know.
No?
I'm trying to decide.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Dr. Valbo, yeah, we could do training mode for a while, but I don't feel like I'm going to learn anything now. I feel like...
We're just going to lose knowledge.
If I had time when I was offline, I could spend a little time trying to learn some of the stuff. All right. So, yeah, we're going to play, I don't know, maybe like 3 or 4 matches here. I'm going to answer some questions. Do a few beat downs. Oh, shit. Oops. Okay. Well, wasting my shit. All right. I like that. Yeah. Wesker. Oh, Wesker's too fast for Sentinel. Is it like... Oh, shit. I like that. Bam! Blam! MODOK! Time for MODOK! Hi-ya!
Yeah, I should've.
Switched?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay. What was that? Is that like fucking the Cosmic Cube?
It might have been.
What? You just pooping out? Come on, MODOK. That's gross. Just putting crap on the ground? Oh, shit. Have some little Sentinel babies. Sentinel babies.
Yeah, this seems like a fair fight.
What, the Hulk?
Well, I mean, Chris did fight a boulder once.
Well, that's
so
true. He does have some experience. Smash! Blam-a-blam-a-blam-a-blam-a. And it's a blam-a-bo! Oh, crossovers! Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Damn it, John. You're messing up my shit. Oh, no!
Well, that's what I'm trying to do here.
Bam!
I mean, I'm going to lose.
Hulk punch.
I know I'm going to lose.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
Because I'm already down 2 people and you haven't lost one.
Blam, MODOK! I kind of like that shield, but what the fuck does it even do? Okay, I don't like MODOK. He's a little weird. Oh, shit! Bam!
There you go. So have you had your first Taco Bell of the year yet?
I have not.
I have.
Have you? What'd you get?
What I usually get, you know, mini quesadillas and loaded grillers, beefy nacho loaded grillers.
Okay.
You know.
Let's see. I'm just going to try out a couple more folks here. I think I never really got a chance to mess with Dormammu. And, oh, no, how about Doctor Strange? It's a very magical Marvel team.
Yeah? Okay. Well, let's see. Who have I been here?
Persona Ico says, between Yakuza 0, Gravity Rush 2, Resident Evil 7, and Kingdom Hearts 2.8, which are you personally looking forward to in January? Whoa, weird.
I mean, for me personally, I'm probably looking forward to...
For me, it's Yakuza 0 and Resident Evil 7 are the two that I'm really looking forward to. I honestly just wish that they would fucking put some out before, like, they all come out kind of at the end of January, and I kind of wish there was more coming out, like, in the middle of January.
Yeah, Resident Evil 7 is probably the big one for me for January.
Huh.
I remember being really good at Marvel's Capcom 2.
Uh-huh.
I'm not, apparently.
Well, it's been a while, too. I mean, you know. It's... Oh, shit. You're like a samurai. Wait, you're like a weird samurai version. What the fuck even was that? How do you grab people in this game? Oh, it's like
oh,
that.
You just did it.
Okay. Oh, he's like disappears. Dormammu. Oh, shoot. Fuck God. Mother. Balls fire. Balls fire. I want to get fucking Stephen Strange up in here. Uh-oh. Yes! It's like zombie Virgil. God damn. How is, I've heard, like, I was talking when Aaron came over to do the Just Dance video.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. All right, well, that was worthless. At least the way that I did it, it was worthless.
Yeah.
I was talking about that Ghost Rider on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has been very, very good.
Did you watch that at all? Yeah, no, it was actually very good. It sucks that, you know, he's left the show, like, they wrote him out of the show because they couldn't actually afford to keep doing the special effects.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they like, wrote him out of the show, and then when people ask, like, oh, is he going to be coming back, you know, because the way they wrote him out, they're like, no, we wrote him out because we couldn't afford to keep him in the show.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But apparently it was very popular. It was really good. Like, I actually really liked it. It was the new Ghost Rider, though.
The one with the little thing on his forehead?
Well, that and the one that drives a car instead of a motorcycle.
You think it'd be easier to do a motorcycle special effect than a car special effect?
Oh, they did both.
Oh, okay.
In the show. Like, there's a whole reference to the previous Ghost Rider to establish that, you know, that Ghost Rider exists.
Okay.
But...
I'm going to pick a rando.
Yeah, I'm just going to go full on rando.
Full rando? Jaime Reyes?
Yes.
Okay. Robbie Reyes.
Robbie.
Jaime Reyes is the
Jaime
Blue Beetle,
Blue
right?
Beetle. Yeah. Okay. Robbie Reyes is...
Epic Gamers saying that you did a really good job with the WWE 2K17 dojo.
Oh.
You like the Royal Rumble, apparently.
Oop. Yeah, I put like the ring, the belt, and like some of the characters online because apparently When you are first starting out, you can only put up a limited number of things on their servers.
Okay.
And you have to get, like, 2,000 downloads of all your stuff combined to be able to get more space to upload more.
Okay.
And I'm like, I'm never going to get 2,000 downloads of any of these characters.
Yeah?
Yeah. So I put up you, Jason, Grant, and Gary Marzipan, and Sarl St. Charles.
Okay.
I wasn't able to put up Loco Steve because the way I used to make him made him not able to be uploaded.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah.
Because when people create stuff from scratch, they can state that people can't re-upload it.
Mm-hmm.
So that if you use any part of what they used,
well,
it makes it not able to be re-uploaded. I could probably remake it a little bit more generic.
Yeah. Is there a way where you can, like, change enough of it so that it'll allow you to do it?
If it uses any portion of that original thing, it won't allow it to be re-uploaded. Because, I mean, and I know in previous versions when they didn't have that, people would, like, someone would make something, and then there would be, like, 20 other people with the exact same. They would just download it and then re-upload it as their own.
Oh, is that why they did it?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, no!
So
ghostly form, you're fucking me up, Steven.
But yeah, so, I mean.
Good Lord.
You know, unfortunately, you know, I can't upload any more than I already have without deleting something that was already there.
Okay.
So.
Let me try some Hero Fest. Would you please hit me? Or, like, attempt to hit me? Oh, nope. Okay. Sorry, that wasn't my intention. Apparently there's a thing where it's like when you block, you can hit two buttons and you'll, like, rush forward. I'm curious to know if that's, like, a meter thing or if that's just a thing that you can do whenever you want to. Wah! Fuck! Oh, jeez, John. Fucking get me out of here.
Well, I was already going to lose. Like, literally, I had a tiny slither of health.
Dark Paul 90 says, my girlfriend and I just made gingerbread men. If I send pictures in this coming week's question, will you be our judges? Sure.
Oh, yeah, sure.
I don't know if I'll actually put the... do you want to play another one? We'll do one more. Let's do one
more. Okay.
Let's do rando on rando. Let's do rando all on rando all.
Hold on.
When I was looking at Amoratsu's name, and it looked like it said anime trash for a second. send him in. Send him on in. D-Hood asks, how's it feel to be doing the puppet again? I'm a little rusty. It's a little odd. But I feel like I'm getting back to it. And Wolverine's got a floaty ass jump. Jeez. Get me out of here.
Take it.
I don't want to. You take it. Akuma. Oh, shit. See, I feel like you're getting your mojo back the longer that we play this, John. You go online with my thing and get all the wins.
No?
How do you get a short you can? Uh-oh, fuck. Too much electric. Swiss cheese. Okay. I feel like there's quite a bit of work like that a person would need to do in this game to figure out like all of the assists that you can do. Shit. Iron Man's almost dead. Get him out of there. I'm more with this Wesker fellow. Seems like an alright guy. Seems like a bloke you can trust.
Yeah, like he'd never betray you.
Yeah. Nope. Whatever that was, it didn't work. Oh, you got my Iron Man out of there.
I also got your Wesker, I think, too.
Oh, wow. Nice. But Wolverine!
He came back in and took it down.
He's the best he is at what he does, yeah. Apparently. All right.
All right. So...
ask that question from Persona Icon.
I was going to kind of go back and look at questions and stuff.
Okay. I'm going to go online.
Looks like there's a few questions here. All right. Here.
Throw them out while I get my ass whooped. I'll get my ass whooped. Okay. So all we got right now is BioPhoenix. You guys send me some invitations, I guess.
Going back to Dr. Von Boogie, he asked about did Robbie Reyes' Ghost Rider have his soulless uncle affixed to him? No, he did not. They actually changed that. Mm. Matter of fact, his uncle was alive and well in the show.
Okay.
So let's see.
Yeah, this person's... connection is all over the place. All right.
Okay, so Dark Devil 2011 says, I have a question. I collect comics from Japanese to American to spend about 50 to 60 euros.
Uh-huh.
But my parents are always tell me that I should save my money or give them my money. How should I react? Should I stop or should I continue? For your information, I have a job.
Okay.
Why should you give them their money if it's your money? Now, here's the thing. You should save some of your money, in all honesty.
Yeah, you should always have a little bit of savings.
Don't be like me, because yeah. I spend my money like crazy. I'm terrible for it. It's a bad habit that I have. I'll spend money when I don't even realize I'm doing it, because I never saved a day in my life. So definitely get in the habit of saving money.
What all this shit that this Phoenix Wright's able to do to me?
Yeah, he knows what he's doing.
Yeah. Damn.
But yeah, definitely save some of your money. What I actually wish I had done, and I try to do more often now, is that, you know, I look at what bills I have to pay. And when I get my paycheck, I go, okay, what bills have to be paid? Okay, I'll use this to pay for that.
Yeah.
And then whatever's left, I'll split up into three categories. One, money to be saved and not to be spent.
Yeah.
Two, money to go towards food and gas and stuff that, you know, is maybe not, like, it's important, but maybe not, like, the most important.
Right.
I mean, food and gas is super important, though.
Yeah.
Having said that. But then also, I have some money that I can just blow. Money that's there to spend on whatever. So, that's kind of, but definitely save some money. I don't know about giving them to your parents. I don't know why they'd want you to do that, but that's.
Well, if they're trying to get you to give them, God damn,
if they're trying
man.
To get you to pay rent, that's another thing. If they're trying to get you to, just trying to help you save money by saying, hey, if you give it to us, we can save it for you.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking more.
Then that's, you know, that's definitely something. But let's see.
I got one of his characters. Fucking Phoenix. Oh, God damn. Yep.
Woo! So, Hideki Itsuno, director of Devil May Cry 3, 4, and Dragon's Dogma, said he'll announce a new game in 2017.
Okay.
Do you think it is a sequel to either franchise, or do you want a new IP out of him?
New IP.
Yeah.
I think Devil May Cry has become kind of toxic, and I feel like if... not toxic isn't the right word. I keep using that word. It just comes to mind, but it's got weird connotations now with a lot of other social issues. But I don't want... I'd like to see him do something new because, one, I like new stuff, and two, I feel like the fan base for Devil May Cry has gotten real weird over the years, and I almost feel like whatever happens, even if he makes a new Devil May Cry, that it will be... it will not be received well no matter how good it is.
Mm.
But that's just me, so... So now I know how to play Phoenix Wright. You gotta, like, that whole, like, get down on the ground and look for stuff thing is, like, how you power up. And then once you power it up, once you get the
So you're collecting evidence and then you... Okay.
No social issues connected to DMC, Dr. Von Boogie. I have been fighting this losing intellectual battle for years about people who are fans of Devil May Cry who just will not stop telling you about how bad DMC is, and it's
John a really
and I,
good game.
John and I have had this conversation a million times, so we don't need to get back into it, but I think that both of us really enjoyed DMC, and I felt like the community around Devil May Cry were super fucking nitpicky with DMC. But that's fine. I also feel like Devil May Cry had two good games, 1 and 3. I thought 4 was okay, and I thought that 2 was bad, so I also feel like the franchise itself has a 50% success rate, which I feel like people overblow of just like, oh my god. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love Devil May Cry 1, and like I'd rather honestly see Capcom go back and like fully remake Devil May Cry 1, like same controls and everything, but just upgrade the visuals so they look like modern. That'd be fun, you know, okay. Rather than just an HD.
Well, I mean, you're more likely to have that because, you know, Capcom just loves re-releasing the same shit.
Very true.
They don't care about making new games anymore.
Yeah. That Devil May Cry 4 release they put out was just like horse shit.
Yeah. Alex Linkowitz asks, a while back I realized that one of my classes requires me to do an internship at a gaming company. So I ask, if you had to take an internship at any game company, which company would you like?
I think it depends on the internship.
I'm going to go with Remedy.
Obviously, Jeff over here is a fan of From Software and, you know, Kojima Productions, right? So let's not pretend like that's not a thing. I also feel like Blizzard is a really I really like how good Blizzard is at making games. So
having worked at Blizzard, it is a very good company to work for. I don't know about internships and stuff like that because that wasn't where I worked.
Wrong attack.
Blizzard's a damn good company.
God damn, I can't seem to make those combos connect even a little bit.
But Blizzard or Remedy for me. You know.
Is that me? Oh shit, okay, that was me. Managed to jam my way out of that a little bit. Oh, god damn! Oh, boy. Which face button do you hit? All of them or just some of them? Because I would like to do that. I would like to break some air combos. Oh, fuck, yep. Nope, okay, trying that. Shit. Nope, not a fan. Fuck. It's funny how we can play Overwatch all weekend.
All damn day long.
And it's fine. Like, it's fine for me to get my ass whooped in Overwatch, and I really just don't mind it. Like, I'll play it by myself and get my ass whooped, but it's just really frustrating here.
Heck, you had fun with playing fucking Battlefront.
Oh, yeah. I fucking love playing Battlefront. It's just games like this. And it's not even this, because we remember I had a really good time playing Rising Thunder online because I felt like I had a good handle on it. Like playing Mortal Kombat online. It's just this game, it always feels like it's... I'm just repeating myself. I'll stop saying it.
D-Hood
has
a question.
See what I'm doing wrong.
If y'all were offered a position to do this kind of stuff professionally, like a publication or news outlet, would you do it or would you prefer to continue just doing this as a hobby? I actually did apply to Giant Bomb when they had an opening. I got a very nice email back saying thank you, but no thank you.
Yeah.
So that was nice. I would do it. I would work at a news publication.
Kind of depends on what they wanted me to do, but probably. Yeah. I mean, I like steady employment is always like doing this for a living is kind of taxing because everything kind of falls on my shoulders. I would really like to work for somebody again because I don't like having to make all the decisions of everything at the top. Like, I prefer being a cog in the machine more than I prefer being you know, like the guy who runs the place, it's a lot easier to just come in and do like somebody. You come in and somebody's like, "Hey, do this," and you'll everything will be fine. And I'm like, "Okay." As opposed to having to make the decisions your own damn self.
Yeah,
it's a lot easier.
Yeah, but yeah, no, I mean, I would totally do it. You know, assuming it was something. I mean, if it was literally just doing what I do here at Rage Select,
yeah,
like nothing else. Like they're just like, no, you just have to come in and do commentary over video games and play video games and you know stuff like that. Then fuck yeah, no, I'd do it. I'd do it in a heartbeat, no questions asked.
Right.
Heck, there was a short time period where. And I won't. I'm not saying what company this was, but there was a period where I was in talks with possibly hosting a live stream for a major company or for a company related to video games, which I would have gotten paid for it, but it didn't go through.
That's cool.
So, don't worry, this website had nothing to do with that, with it not going through. In case anyone was worried,
as
like...
As far as John knows, that is...
Don't, you know, no, it was just more of a... I kind of, when it was brought to my... When it was proposed to me, because it didn't come from me, like, I didn't propose it to them. Mm-hmm. They came to me. It was one of those things where I was like, this ain't ever going to happen.
Yeah.
Kind of thing, so... And it did. Nothing ever came of it. But Persona Ico wants to know, so with Mass Effect Andromeda's release date now announced and out in the wild, what don't you want to see in this new game?
Reapers. Definitely Reapers. I don't want it to be a game where at the end it turns out, oh my god, the Reapers are back.
The Reapers are now in this new galaxy.
Right, yeah. That is the last thing in the world that I want to see is more goddamn Reapers.
Yeah, I can kind of agree with that. It needs to be something new. Something different. But...
Sorry, I'm
I'll say, if people want to know, the reason that they came to me because of the people that knew about it knew I did Geek Bombast a long while back. So, like, that was their point of reference for me. And while I'd never done, like, video game Let's Plays, they knew I had also done them because I'd mentioned it.
Yeah.
But it was more, they were more familiar with what I had done on Geek Bombast. So, like, it was more, like, that was why they... And I knew how to do the stuff that they were wanting to do. So.
Oh fuck.
Dark Devil 2011 wants to know: is there a video game in this new year that you are most excited for?
Oh, so many.
There are so many. Red Dead 2.
Oh shit! Still alive.
For Honor.
Persona 5.
Persona 5. Yeah.
This year or this month, I'm interested in Resident Evil 7, Yakuza 0, New Yakuza. Yeah, lots of stuff.
Mass Effect Andromeda.
Yeah, I'll play Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm trying to think. These days I always have to pull up a list because I always forget some of them. Like, there's so many that are slated that I have a hard time remembering all of them. Oh, yeah. Persona Ico says Nier Automata. We played the demo for that. It was good.
Spoilers.
Yeah. Spoilers for...
for something that we haven't posted on the site.
True. Yes. Yes. Yeah, Red Dead 2 is 2018, says Dr. Sirakas.
Oh, is it 2018? I thought they said 2017 for that.
I don't know. It wouldn't surprise me. I mean, the dev time on those takes so long. You can look it up on the interwebs. I mean, at this point, I'm so used to shit being pushed out and delayed that it wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't surprise me if it was never even there in the first place, but I just wish there was more stuff in January. Like, I'm really having a hard time. I think I'm going to have to go back and play some games for that I missed in 2016 next week, because I'm just not going to fucking go buy Hatsune Miku fucking DX whatever. Alex?
Yeah, it says fall 2017.
Okay.
Red Dead Redemption 2 says fall 2017.
Okay.
So it's coming out this year.
I mean, it doesn't mean it won't get pushed back. But that's what it says on their website right now. Alex, yeah, we're probably not going to play the Gravity Rush 2 demo just because Gravity Rush 2 is going to be out before the end of the month. That demo dropped like in December when we were doing other stuff. I downloaded it. I may play it personally, but I don't think we're going to feature it on the website at all because, I mean, you know, I don't think there's any real reason for that. Jeez.
I'm looking forward to Hand of Fate 2.
Okay. Maybe I should try playing some of the characters that have been whooping my ass, John. Like Dante and
maybe.
Virgil.
Yeah.
Persona Ico, there's so much stuff coming out early this year because the fiscal year ends in March, so companies can put stuff out in the first 3 months of this year and still have them on their books, have the sales on their books when they're talking about their profits for the last fiscal year. So that's why that is. God damn. Every time I get... Oh, fucking hell. Every time I get up in the air, I forget to do... I just got no control over what the fuck I'm doing here. All right. Oh, my good lord. So, apparently, we're going to have one win and, like, a million losses in this Sunday. Because this guy with Spider-Man could just kill all three of my characters before anything even happens. It doesn't help that I don't actually know how to fucking play as Dante.
Let's see. Here's some games I'm looking forward to this year in order of release. Resident Evil 7, Yakuza 0, Neo, For Honor, Horizon Zero Dawn,
oh,
Mass Effect Andromeda,
mm-hmm.
South Park The Fractured But Whole, Persona 5, Injustice 2, Final Fantasy 7 Remake. Mm-hmm. Though I actually don't really care. Actually, that one I'm not actually so much excited for. Agents of Mayhem.
Oh, yeah. I keep forgetting about that's...
That one I'm really excited about. God of War I'm interested in. Zelda Breath of the Wild. The new Spider-Man game, Prey. I'm interested to hear more about Detroit Become Human.
Yeah.
If anything, because, you know, while I hate David Cage as a director, I do... on some level enjoy his game, so there's that. Death Stranding has a 2017 release date on it from everything I'm seeing, but like that ain't coming out this year. That there's no way.
I highly doubt it. It would be very surprising. It would be incredibly surprising. I'm not going to say never, but it would be incredibly surprising.
Yeah. I really want to know when they're going to fucking release Crackdown. That doesn't even have a year release date yet.
Yeah.
They literally announced that shit and then never talked about it ever again.
Alex, I don't care about, like, I don't get as upset about the whole, like, always online thing. It doesn't really matter to me. I mean, I agree that it's not not great, but I'm not one of those people who's going to be like, fuck it, I'm not going to play that game just because it's always online. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I genuinely don't like it when companies do that, but at this point, like, I would not play the game because of that. Did Diablo 3 ever get an offline mode? Does he still have to be online all the time?
I think you still have to be online for that.
Yeah. Scalebound. Scalebound doesn't do anything for me.
Yeah.
I keep seeing videos for Scalebound, and it looks... I don't like the character, like, with his headphones, his Beats headphones, with his dragon. Like, I'm kind of like, be medieval.
Isn't that the same
or...
guy who made Bayonetta?
I think
like directing
so.
That?
I have no idea, but that sounds right. Could be wrong. All I know is that I just don't like... Whenever they show it, I just don't like what I see of it, so... Alright, let me go back to my stable of people that I was playing as. Get my ass kicked several more times. Low energy Starman. Yeah, we said Nier Automata.
Well, I
you
think
might
because,
have just joined in.
Well, also when I was reading off my list, I didn't mention it because I didn't have it on. I didn't have it on the list that I'd had that I was looking at.
This guy's got 2 wins and 22 losses, John. I don't know. Maybe. Just scratching his butt over there.
This guy does the same thing that you were proposing earlier in the stream.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you suck at this game? Do you need to get your...
Right. Do you need to get some wins? Come fight Rage Select. We don't know how to do shit. God damn it. Nope. That was a bad move. Ooh, air throw. I didn't even know I could do that.
Dark Devil 2011 wants to know what would you think of a crossover between Devil May Cry and Bayonetta? Since they're both of the same creator.
I don't want that. I want more Bayonetta proper games. I don't want Bayonetta in other games. I just want to play more Bayonetta games. Fucking hell. Can't tell where anything is. Oh, fuck. Oh, well, that was a waste of whatever that was.
Yeah, it was. That's okay.
We're reaching that point, John.
Yeah?
We're getting there.
Yeah?
Yeah, that point where I'm just like, fuck it, and I throw my controller at the wall. This is one of the only games in the world that makes me do this. I play Bloodborne all the live long day. I get killed fucking all the time. I get invaded in Dark Souls 3, and people are all good, and they kill me. Like, I don't mind being killed by other people, but this shit just pisses me off. Just because... I just don't feel like I know what the fuck is going on. I just don't feel like I know what the fuck is going on or what to do to stop what's going on from going on. So. Player 2 wins. I get the cover of the next Street Fighter for this, right, Capcom? Right? Who's doing the voice of...
It's Nolan North.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Nolan North has done every video game incarnation of Deadpool.
Kaneta,
he's also done a few animated incarnations of Deadpool as well.
I'm pretty good with either Bayonetta, short or long hair. I think I kind of like long hair Bayonetta better because the whole her hair is her outfit thing was so weird, but I don't mind changing stuff around. Epic Gamer, this guy has 22 losses because everybody else is way better than I am.
We're just that bad.
Do you want to play? Please put me out of my misery for a few minutes, John. Give me a little time to unsalt myself.
All right.
I gotta go scrape some of this
unsalt
salt.
Yourself.
Yeah.
Just don't do it in front of me because that's disgusting.
Desalt myself. Assault myself?
No.
Okay.
Do I have to hit something to be ready?
Yeah. Hit a button.
Oh.
You're ready. The superheroes are all here, John. His like, when you were picking Iron Fist and it was like his assist move or whatever, I thought it said tits up for a second.
Yeah, we'll go with that one. And then let's go with... You know what we'll do?
X23, huh? X gonna give it to you? Like he was doing rails of coke, but salt. Snorting rails of salt? That sounds incredibly painful.
Yeah, that's weird. Stop talking about your ass, Jeff.
No, never! My ass is perky. Oh, dude, watch out. He's getting all his things. Watch out. He's all powered up now. He's going to fucking object. Once he objects, then it's all over. You're going to die. Or maybe not. I don't know. You just did some fucking super magic. Uh-oh, Dr. Doom. Yeah, when I was in actually in animation school, it might have been when this came out.
Yeah,
that can't be right. No, it had to be.
Well, the first one it could have been because remember, there's two versions of Marvel's Capcom 3.
Okay, maybe it was. I'm just trying to remember which one we played on Spill, whether it was the first or whether it was Ultimate. I just remember people having conversations
playing very cheaply.
Well, quit letting him do that.
Yeah, so that's what he does. It's like if you get in close.
But yeah, I remember the kids in that class talking about this game and just like, and I had fun watching it when I was watching it at Evo, because I could kind of understand a little bit when I was watching and not having to play at the same time. But it just seems like the muscle memory of what to do when and how to do stuff and how just to close distance and attack just seemed lost on me. Dark Paws, what are your actual will-do New Year's resolutions this year? I don't make resolutions.
I don't have a New Year's resolution per se, but there are certain things that I do plan to do.
What the fuck? Ty Comstock says, I love having the puppet intros back. You're welcome. If you love them, share them. Share them with friends and family and other people and let people know about them. Yeah. Hey, Marvel vs. Capcom. All right. You play a little versus? I'm tired of just seeing you lose screens, butts getting kicked.
It's up to you, man.
Okay. Let's play a little versus. Jump back out and do a little bit more verses. What do you do? Do you think good with player points? Are people like juicing with the player points? That's how
I have no idea.
Don't share the puppet intros with children. Sorry, did I say that? Kodahita, please don't do that. That's not a good thing. I don't want anybody to do that. Let's see, I'm gonna do some Marvel Ladies, and I haven't played as X-23 yet. Here we go. Oh, Ty Comstock, no problem. He asked me for some advice about green screen. I told him to go buy some lights. Oh, they've got the... Oh, wait. Go back to the alt Trish? Oh, that's the Devil May Cry 4 when Trish is in disguise. She's that other character that's flirting with Nero. Oh. Well, see, the thing Darkpaul90 about doing like a full puppet skit episode is... I don't know. I've got some plans. That might be something that comes in the future. It just kind of depends on... kind of the growth of Rage Select over the next few months and if there is any and just kind of how this stuff all shakes out. I mean, the thing is that the puppet intros are back in an attempt to try to hopefully maybe gain some of the folks back who I guess left last year. But if they don't, like, the problem with the puppet intros from before is if the puppet intros don't get us any growth, then there's kind of a question of why? Why bother doing them if they don't actually help us really at all, so. Ooh, Chun-Li. Wait, did the music just change to Chun-Li's
yes.
theme?
Yes.
That's cool. Oh, what the fuck? Whoa, wait, what's that robot doing back there? Has that robot always been there?
Yeah.
John, look at the robot. Stop
no.
fighting me. Stop winning, John, and look at the robot.
I'm not winning, you jerk.
Oh, are you not? I'm sorry. Oh, god damn. Oh, jeez. Well, jeez. Dark Devil 2011 asks, have you thought about doing a Weeaboo Week on Rage Select with Jason or Grant or Brian Brushwood? I don't understand how many times I have to explain to people that, like, Jason and Grant and Brian Brushwood fucking hate JRPGs, and if I just only invite them over to play games that they hate, like, that's not fun for them. I mean, I know that people like to like watch them rage, but they legitimately don't like them. Like, they don't enjoy them, and they have a bad time. They have a legitimate bad time when they come over to play those sorts of games. So I generally try not to inflict that upon people.
Yeah.
Well, I know it's for the views, but they won't come. Like, if you make Grant just play nothing but JRPGs, eventually it stops. Like, it doesn't actually get us any more views if Grant is upset.
So we're not playing versus
anymore? Oh, no. Go back in. I'm sorry. I was just exiting that. Like, the people that know Rage Select, they'll watch whether Grant is on...
I don't know why I went to training. I'm
training.
Sorry. I don't know why I did that.
And, like, the people who just find us on the internet, they hate that shit because it's just a person crapping on a genre that they like. So let's say that you're a person who's really into JRPGs and you find Grant just complaining and complaining and complaining about how stupid he thinks JRPGs are. They don't like that. Like, they may hate watch it, and they may go into the comments and be real shitty about it, but they don't enjoy it. I mean, only the regular folks from Rage Select think that it's really funny. So I don't know.
Man, I wish I could also do a Mega Man.
You do Zero with that Mega Man skin.
Yeah, but I want to do Zero and Mega Man. Man, you don't understand.
Beautiful Joe on Beautiful Joe action, huh?
Yeah.
Double beautiful. Ty Comstock, it was a hard... Ty Comstock is asking what our favorite indie games of last year were. I feel like it was a much harder... That's a very hard decision for 2016 because Steam was so goddamn full of shit.
Actually, when we did our best of, like, a lot of, there were actually include a lot of a few indie games on
yeah,
that list.
He mentioned that, but Super Hot, that many.
You know, Super Hot, Layers of Fear, you know.
God damn, Rocket Raccoon. Low Energy Starman, I don't do social media that well. I'm sure that it would probably help the website if I did, but I just, like, I never feel like I have anything to say, and that I just, like, feel like it's kind of self-indulgent a lot of times. I don't know. Usually I only post stuff when I have something to say, but usually, like, you know, I don't know. We do so many goddamn shows every week that I feel like I need to save my energy and the things that I have to say for things like the podcast, not just kind of throw them out on social media. You know. You play Beautiful Show, John?
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah. They're very good games.
Okay. Uh-oh. Oh, shit! Got everybody out there. Uh-oh.
Aw. Sorry, Trombone.
Jeezy.
Oh, I thought I'd gotten your Beautiful Joe out. I guess I didn't. I guess I only got Arthur.
Nope. I'm not really even sure what the moveset on Beautiful Joe is like. Ugh.
You won.
Okay. I can't read all the things you guys are saying. I'm trying to actually fight John
as well.
Yeah,
we were trying to play at the same time.
I'll fight some more. I'll get my ass whooped online a little bit more. What's our time looking like as well?
Actual.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to need that.
It is 5:34.
Okay, so we got about a half hour left.
Yep.
Dark Devil 2011 wants to know if you've thought about doing a face cam or something for the live stream.
I have. I don't know that it would really help. I don't know. I have thought about that. I mean, in the few times that we've done face cam stuff, even with Let's Plays, I feel like it doesn't really make much of a difference, and the setup that I've got here doesn't lend itself super well to that. We could, I guess, but it... yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. We're just talking about social media and exposure. Exposing themselves.
Yeah. You don't want us exposing ourselves. I don't know, folks. We had this conversation a while back on stuff. I'm going to be trying a couple things the next coming months, but in all honesty, like, I'm not the guy. Like, I'm not the, like, butterfly, social butterfly who does, like, super collaborative, you know, kind of stuff and is going to be emailing everybody. I'm just not, like, it just doesn't really work as well for me. So I don't know. I mean, I might be looking for, like, a volunteer to help me out with some of that stuff. To maybe do some stuff on my behalf, but it's not the sort of stuff that I'm good at on my own.
Oh, look, it's the level that is based on one of my most disliked Daredevil storylines.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he ends up... The Hand ends up going to him and saying, we want you to take over as the leader of the Hand.
Okay.
And he basically goes, no, you're my sworn enemy. No, never. Mm-hmm. And so then they go to Wilson Fisk, and they're like, hey, we want you to take over as the leader of the Hand. And he realizes that, you know, that's worse.
Fuck.
And that if he's the leader of the Hand, maybe he can change them from the inside kind of thing. So he takes over the Hand. And it turns out it was all a ploy, and they actually had him possessed by a demon. And he turned evil.
Yeah.
And turned Hell's Kitchen into a...
God, what the fuck? I mean, as soon as he was done with that combo... I started trying to hit him, and he just blocked all of them. Like, what the fuck do I have to do to even hit somebody in this goddamn game? Fuck face. Sorry.
No, I get it.
Frustrating. That's what it is. Anywho, sorry.
Yeah, no.
You were talking about Wilson Fisk.
Yeah, no. Actually, I was well past that.
Okay.
I was just like, Daredevil ends up becoming the leader of the Hand, and instead of changing them from the inside, he actually gets possessed by a demon and turns evil.
Oh.
And then starts killing people.
Okay.
So.
Does Stick have to come beat the demon out of him?
No, Stick is actually part of the problem.
Oh, okay. So who's going to beat the hell out of him?
Iron Fist beat the demon out of him? I forget who does. I think, like, Elektra does it. Elektra is the one who, like... makes him realize he was wrong or whatever. It was a fucking terrible story arc, and it was so there became this thing where it was really, which I don't really understand it, and I'm glad that they've stopped doing it.
Yeah.
But there became this thing to write Daredevil into a corner.
Okay.
That the idea is, oh, well, how's he going to come back from this?
Yeah.
But you write him into a corner that's so bad, you then leave the book and leave the next writer to pick up the pieces.
Oh, shit.
And it became a challenge between the writers at Marvel to do this.
No, really?
Yeah, yeah. So, like, one writer ended up revealing that Daredevil is Matt Murdock to the public, and then also had Matt Murdock get arrested and put in prison with everyone knowing that he's Daredevil.
Yeah.
And then left the book. And the next writer wrote him getting out of that, and then ended it with the Hand thing.
Yeah.
Or him, you know, the whole Hand coming to him to... Like, it was literally, like, they just kept making it worse and worse and worse and worse. You know, situation. And then they basically, like... And then basically the sales in the book were getting bad, so they had the writer in the series, essentially. And then they relaunched the book with a new writer.
Yeah.
Which... I appreciate what the new writer, who was Mark Waid did, which was he kind of took that thing of you know, write Daredevil into a corner and then try to figure it out.
Yeah.
Except he did it to himself. Every story arc ended with something happening that he had to then come up with a way to like, he would just, but he wouldn't do it like, he was like, oh, I'm just going to shit on Daredevil's life or just make Daredevil's life even worse. It was literally, he would just make it like an impossible situation. And then the idea would be like, okay, now how do I write him out of this situation? But I don't know.
Oh, fuck face. Fuck's sake.
Berserker Flash. But yeah, no, it's, you know.
Oh, he's building up that fucking meter forever and to get one of those, like, and then I kill all of your people! Fuck it, though.
Let's go, Jeff. You could do this.
I'm going to try. I'm going to try something. Ah, fuck. Nope. That wasn't what I was trying to do. Who got killed there? Akuma?
Yeah, yes.
I'm down to just Captain America.
And Ryu.
Wait, I don't have... Oh, yeah, I do have some Ryu, don't I?
Well, he got rid of his Wolverine, and now he's only got Akuma.
Yep.
Which, you know.
God, my hands are fucking burning up.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, my hands just aren't used to that.
Oh, shit. He's got so much more meter than I do at this point. I wish I could remember what to do.
Oh, remember, fuck. Jeff, it's not the size of the meter, but how you use it.
And he used it well. He used it very well. Motherfucker, motherfucker. Ah, jeez. That wasn't going so bad. Just kind of wish that I could win a few games. Can I play in the baby league? Is there a baby league that I can opt into at this point?
I thought that's what we did. I thought that's just like being amateur was...
Puts like a little pink bow on our character. I'll take any amount of humiliation to win a few online matches at this point. Hey, here's somebody who asked to play us. Let's see. Okay. Oh, this invitation can no longer be used. It didn't pop up. Dark Paul, if you want to volunteer, mail at rageselect.com is good. I'm going to send out some people, some kind of folks that I'm looking for in the Patreon email this week. So if you're a patron, that's usually the first place that I go to is our patrons. Those are usually some very... some of our staunchest fans. Yeah, it turns out that this is just like a big ruse and that we're both like fucking grandmasters at this game.
No, what y'all don't understand is I've already been to Evo. They don't allow me back.
So I
was too good because I won all the tournaments that one year.
Yeah,
it's the year you don't hear about very often.
Oh yeah, the tournament
year. Yeah, like all like I played two games at the exact same time and won both tournaments. It was crazy. Like I'm not allowed. Like they literally said, John, you're too good.
You're too good, John. You can't come back anymore.
You can't come back. You're not allowed. We won't sell you tickets.
Yeah.
So
we're not. You're not allowed. And yeah. Fucking.
Yeah, but so I'm not allowed back there anymore. So
Holy
I can't go to Evo. Sorry.
What? Alex, at this point, I mean, I appreciate all the stuff that people are saying. Like somebody was saying we should do like specialized Patreon videos that are like half highlight videos and half like puppet commentary over the videos. That's fine and everything, but that's like we put out 10 videos, a 3-hour live show, and a 2.5-hour podcast every week. Like there's some limits as to what else can be done. And the problem that I keep coming back to, I think that we talked about this a little bit on the podcast, was that if I could be guaranteed that doing that was going to definitely get us more subscribers, I would do it. But otherwise, it's like a whole bunch of work. And if it just does nothing, it's adding it's taking away from the time that I have to actually have a life and not get completely burned out. And if it doesn't actually like improve our subscribership, then the benefits are somewhat dubious. And unfortunately, I'm just not, like, I don't know enough about how this thing works. And I'm also a little bit obstinate about kind of like, oh, look, he's got a little Ant-Man.
Yeah.
About, like, if people really just don't want to watch Rage Select, like, because we've had subscribers that have left, and if people don't want to watch Rage Select, I mean, I don't want to, like, flog a dead horse. Like, we'll just close this shit up, and I'll go get a day job, and we'll do this shit on the weekends. Like, it's not, you know, it's not the end of the world, but I don't want to just, you know, spend all day, every day trying to come up with something to I don't know. It just, it's frustrating. It's frustrating when you put all of what you got into a thing and people are like, well, you should just do three or four more things in addition to the... I mean, I was stayed up until 9 a.m. on Thursday just trying to get that... that Walking Dead intro finished. And then it had a fucking typo in it.
Did it?
Yeah. Yeah. I wrote dumpster fire without a P. So it just says dumpster fire. I'm just like, fuck. You know how much render time and upload time it's going to take to put the P in that dumpster fire?
Nah, fuck that. Just leave it. Adds character.
Yes, it does. I was just surprised that on the website that nobody seemed to catch it. Usually the website, this is back when it, like, it only, when it went to YouTube that it was picked up. I don't think I've managed to land a single attack. Like, he's just jumping all around me, flying around, doing stuff, and I'm just not... Nope. There we go. Hey, I got an attack! I hit him one time, y'all!
Also, going back to my Evo stories, Diago would be embarrassed if he fought me.
Yeah.
Embarrassed at how easily he kicked my ass.
Do you want to... Like, I'm going to play with my feet for a little bit in this match because... Let's see. I'm going to turn the controller upside down. Maybe that'll help. I don't... Doesn't... No. Okay. Wait, did I hit him back off of me? I feel like I should just stand here and let him... Let him... All right! Fun!
But,
Yep.
Someone did ask, are fans allowed to make highlight videos? Which I don't know what that means exactly.
I download it and put together like a best of. I'm actually going to try to maybe put some folks together to do that, like, for the site on its, you know, like, as a thing. We used to do it. We did it a little bit when we were doing the Dojo Minis, but Grant was kind of like running that group of people. And then when Grant left, like, I just never picked it back up again. So I'm thinking about trying to put something like that, put a group of people together to do something like that. Dark Devil 2011, I mean, be real honest with you. Like, I don't know. I don't like streaming on Twitch as much as I like making, like, full-on videos for YouTube. Like, I don't know. I mean, maybe it's because, like, half of last year, the chat room was trying to, like, piss me off for a while. I feel like you guys have stopped doing that, but...
Yeah, it's my job.
I don't like it when, like, rando people come in and start being shitty, like that one guy earlier. Or when people show up and they're just like, fuck, you suck, you jaw your shit. Or, like, when we're playing Dark Souls 3 one time and I was just losing and there was somebody in there that was just trying to, like, dictate how I played the entire time. Like, the interaction, a lot of times, just makes me mad. And I'm sorry. I mean, I love you guys, but it's also much longer. Like, it's so much longer sometimes. Sometimes when we're playing a game that I really enjoy, I really like it because we just get to play something fun. But sometimes it just drags. I don't know.
Yeah, it just depends on the game.
Yeah.
I love the chat. I love all interaction with chat. I don't care if I'm on a video, on a stream, or if the chat's not there. I'm up for it all. But then again, I don't have to deal with this shit after it's all said and done.
Yeah.
I'm not the one who has to edit it all together and make it all look pretty.
Yeah, Metal Gear Ray, I've totally considered doing a new Patreon intro video with the puppets. It's just I would need time to do that. That's kind of the problem that we keep coming back to is time. Is that it would take away a part of my life to do that.
Well, it's like, you know, I actually, I never noticed that in the background.
What's that?
The mutant sign. The mutant sign, but you'll notice Mega Man's on it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's got some, like, Capcom characters on it as well.
Yeah. But I actually watched the Patreon video that you have for the site.
Yeah.
And while, yes, it's...
It sucks.
It's the first video. It's with you and Jason. It's literally... But it's actually pretty informative.
Yeah.
Compared to...
There's work that needs to be done there. It's just kind of, it comes, like, somebody was trying to become a patron, and apparently when you try to do that, like, it doesn't give you the opportunity. It basically, all it asks you is, like, well, how much money a month do you want to give? Or how much money per video do you want to give without any additional information? So there's a lot of Q&A that needs to be done with that, and I've got, like, friends and a family and things that I want to be doing that's not just Rage Select, like 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And it may be that the answer at this point is going to be that the only way for Rage Select to succeed is going to be for me to do it 24 hours a day and not have a life. Because that's what I did for the first 2 years that we had the site. And then last year I kind of tried to, like, give myself a little bit of free time, and we lost a bunch of subscribers and people stopped watching and they didn't like it, blah, 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 blah. So, I don't know. But if that's what happens, like, I have a problem with that, because it means that the website will go until the day where I freak the fuck out and I just go nuts and just shut everything down and walk away from it, because I get so frustrated because I literally have nothing in my life except for this one thing. So, which is also, it's a little bit more dramatic than it needs to be, honestly. It's just tiring, you guys.
Yeah.
It's like we're coming up on year 4 of Rage Select, and there are problems that need to be done, and it gets real tiring, and it's a lot of times, God, fuck you, you fucking piece of shit. It's just real hard sometimes.
After this match, you want to hand it back to me?
Yes, please. Ugh.
It's also 551.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
All right, lightning round. Sorry, folks. Sorry. I'm sorry for being frustrated and salty and shit. This is the funniest thing when I'm all just like, oh god, let's talk about how everything is just the worst. But yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna try.
You know what's not the worst?
What's that?
Puppies.
Puppies are the wait. You know what? Let's you and I play each other. Like, let's. You want to do that, or do you want to just go online and do the thing?
We can play. We can do the online mode or offline mode. We can do a little bit more verses.
Ooh, working at Taco Bell. That sounds great. That sounds great if Taco Bell paid like $14 or $16 an hour. I just want to play some characters I haven't ever played before.
Thor?
Yeah. Burritos or burgers, John?
Kind of like both.
Yeah. Which one do you like better? With an evil genie is going to remove the one that you like least from the entire world.
Burgers, I guess.
You'd let burritos go by the wayside?
Yeah.
Okay. Ketchup or mustard?
Ketchup.
By the way, for me, it's burgers and mustard.
You know what? I'll go with Deadpool.
Deadpool.
Actually, no, I'm not going to go with that costume.
Is this the regular Deadpool? Is that like reverse Deadpool?
Yeah.
Nega Deadpool? Deadpool!
I'll go with that one.
Oh, like X-Men Deadpool? I'm Dr. Fucking Doom! You bow down before Doom, Captain Rogers! Bam! Oh, I just saw, like, evil Daredevil back there. I don't think I saw him before because I was too busy getting my ass kicked. It's like a fucking... He's like Shao Kahn!
Yeah, it's part of, like, Shadowland is what it was called, the story arc.
Yeah.
I think I said Dark Reign earlier. It's Shadowland.
Thor is a fucking Asgardian boar. Ah, shitty. Fucking fuckery. Thor! Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Hawkeye.
What?
Does he have the Ant-Man with him? Are they like besties or something in the comics?
Oh, I have. I mean, they did that in like one comic. Mm-hmm. It's such an iconic image,
yeah,
that they constantly reuse it. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Damn. You getting that like that. All three bangers going on there.
No, it was only two.
Anywho. Sorry, folks. We're going to play something different next week that's going to be a lot less like making me upset and angry. Oh, shit. No, no. Oh, Captain Rogers. Oh, shit. Nice, John. See, John's showing that he actually knows, like, all about this game. He's just been laying low, trying to get me to bet him money on a match.
Yeah, good thing we bet a fiver on this one.
Yeah.
You guys just didn't know.
There's a lot of hand signals in Sunday streaming that you guys aren't privy to. Oh, fuck. Damn. My Thor. You still got all three of your people. Oh, shit.
Oh, you just go spam Blaster.
How about
man?
That? Did you like when that other guy did that? What about it when I do it? Oh, no. I'm almost dead with Dr. Doom. Oh. Crap. I was recording it, Deadpool. That's cool.
But don't worry, it's recorded.
Yeah, you don't have to come to my house. I'm just going to go randos. Randos!
Rando McRandomson.
All right. Who's the best Ghost Rider, John?
Like character?
Yeah.
Probably Danny Ketch. I would be more of a big fan, but I really like Robbie Reyes, but he's too new for me to be able to say, like, he's the best one.
The fuck do I shoot this gun?
But I came in with the Danny Ketch era. That's kind of where I started, so he's kind of my... But like I said, I really like Robbie Reyes.
Okay.
I just feel like he's too new for me to be able to say he's the best because they could still fuck it up.
Yeah. Bam, bam, blammo. Bang, bang, blangity. Who's that, Wesker?
Yeah.
I have a hard time understanding what Wesker's... Oh, okay. Oh, Wesker! Ha-ha! But what the hell was that? Was that like all the lasers? Why isn't Mega Man in this game?
Because they went with Zero this time.
Is he in the previous games?
Yes.
Does Zero play like Mega Man?
Yes.
Okay.
Mega Man is also an alt skin for Zero. Well, I mean,
yeah,
you know,
I saw that. Damn, he's got a hell of a reach on him.
Well, I wish I had known that was a close proximity attack.
Yeah.
Well, shit balls.
Yep. Huh, all right. Oh, fuck. Uh-oh.
Man, yeah, what but you blocked.
What a shit is Wesker. His character's like super just like, oh, hi, I'm Wesker.
Good right. job, Jeff, because it's 6 p.m.
Is that it?
You win. You ended it on...
On time.
On time.
Excellent. All right. Well, thanks, everybody. I only managed to freak out once, maybe twice. Sorry for any of the stuff. You watch this in replay. Sorry about all the heavy stuff. This is not my intention to do this every week. Next week, we'll figure something out. Thanks, everybody, for watching live. And thanks for all of the suggestions and such that you guys put out there. I know that sometimes it may seem like I'm just like, nah. But, you know, I do listen to that stuff. It's just, it's been a frustrating. 2016 was frustrating for me in a lot of ways. So the podcast is coming up in probably about an hour, maybe 90 minutes.
I'm on it.
John's on it this week. Shocker, I know.
I ended the year and I started the new year.
Damn right. It's the year of John here on Rage Select. Come back to the website and then we'll see you next week. We stream here every Sunday if you're new, and we'll see you next time.
Later.